You just mentioned there about sort of no knickers and that.
Is this going to be your Auntie Nora?
No. Right. It's just, you know, like the last flat that I lived in, I always had a good view across the road and I could see, it was the hairy.
There was the hairy Chinese kid.
Not hairy Chinese kid, he was just a Chinese kid, actually.
Yeah.
Running about. Because that's rare, isn't it? Hairy Chinese kid's very rare, isn't it?
Yeah.
There's only one official sighting, isn't there? In one of those shit little magazines that you buy.
Yeah, he was running around in his underpants.
Did you, sorry, you just swore ironically. I mean, I imagine if there's any newspapers listening, you did that because you're sort of jokey and...
Yeah, go on, let's not swear.
And there was
go
the
on.
Old woman who didn't move, she was just sat there reading the book all
who
the time.
Who we think possibly died and no one came round for weeks,
But, and now I've moved, right? And it was quiet for a bit. I always look at what view I'm getting, right? Looks across and it was just sort of empty, sort of flats ready for people to move in and that, right? Anyway, people are in there now, right? And they've put all the furniture in, but haven't put any curtains up.
Oh.
Right. So anyway, I'm sort of washing up, just having a look out the window.
Yeah.
Right. Girl sort of, wandering about, you know, knickers on. Right.
With no knickers on.
You mean naked?
No knickers. Well, she had a bra on.
Right,
but,
okay.
But,
she's probably looking for a knicker.
So, I thought, oh. And I don't know how long I was looking.
No.
Right. But anyway, she looks across.
God.
I think she spotted me.
Yeah.
I think, oh, God. I felt really bad.
Yeah.
I said to Suzanne...
Sorry, is this some sort of Peeping Tom confession while the Telegraph are listening?
I've no idea.
Well, it's not... That's the thing, though.
Peepington.
If I was peeping, she was peeping as well, because she was looking over. Works both ways, doesn't it?
Yeah, but all she could see of you was your bald head.
Yeah.
No,
but and your hands moving as you were washing up. And some white-looking substance.
Particularly stubborn stain on this glass.
Yeah.
Oh God!
Imagine that. Imagine if she looked across. I'm assuming the sink is lower than the window.
But didn't she just like just cover up or something? Or she looked back and go, "Oh, you looking at my fanny?"
Well, the thing I did.
What?
I thought, oh, just sort of drop me boxer shorts. Because I
thought.
Well, Suzanne said, "What are you doing?
What are you talking about? What are you talking about?
No, just so they can see me cheeks of me.
What are you talking about?
No, this because I thought if she thinks I'm walking about in the nude as well, then we've both got something out of it.
Carl,
this sounds like a bad excuse in court.
I know.
This is
all the plot of a film on Channel 5.
I mean, this is like the doctor who got done right for exposing himself to a patient and set and brought and then painted that little thing. That you look down their throat, pink.
Yeah.
And going, this is what they saw.
Yeah.
No, so sorry, you immediately, so you were looking at a woman dancing around naked, right? So the only thing you could do was immediately drop your boxer shorts.
So she looked across, saw you fully clothed, saw you took your boxer shorts.
No, she wouldn't have done because it's sort of just the top half and the sink's at a side angle, so I was sort of looking out.
So this is genius.
So she wouldn't have seen your trousers then anyway?
No, she did. I moved in front of the window.
So you then made her.
Oh, this is amazing!
So you climbed in front of the window to show off.
No, it wasn't
naked lower.
Suzanne said, "What are you doing?"
And I said, bet she did.
What are you looking at?
So I sent you in here to clean up.
What are you doing? I'm just taking my trousers down, standing by the window. Why? Because there's a naked woman across the road. What do you think I'm doing, Suzanne? I'm exposing myself while looking at some free funny.
Leave it.
What's up with you, Suzanne?
Leave it.
Christ.
Are we doing Rockbusters? Or
yeah.
What?
Oh,
she sent you in there to read up on Einstein.
Oh, brilliant!
Wait a minute. Can I just check? A final question. What did the woman across the way, what happened? What was her reaction?
I didn't look again, I just thought, you've seen a bit of action as well, we're both happy. Let's leave it.
Brilliant.
So were you waddling around like a penguin with your trousers around your ankle?
I just was walking about and Suzanne said, what are you doing? I said, I'll explain to you in a bit, but don't look out the window because then it's
excellent.
Obvious.
Yeah. Then he sees, that she calls her husband to look at Carl walking around naked, he goes, oh, she's got a, quick Suzanne, get him out.
Yeah.
There's only one with England, get some more friends, they've gone one more.
Anyway.
Brilliant. Right, play a record.
So read about.
Sharks, monkeys or jellyfish?
It's 10 past, isn't it? We haven't done a little bit of knob news.
No, right? We haven't done knob news, no.
But,
it's been 3 months. It's been 3 months coming.
There's this thing, I don't know the full story, I don't know how it happened, right, but little Russian fella.
Yeah.
He was, sort of having sort of emptying his bladder, right, and somehow electrocuted himself.
Right.
And, sort of did a bit of damage.
How did he smashed into some live wires or something?
Something like that.
So did anyway, damage to himself or to an electric fire or something?
No, to himself.
To himself.
Yeah. And so the doctor
didn't slip and curling tongs went up his ass when he was pissed, because that's happened a lot. In
yeah, we've
hospitals.
All been there.
We've all shoved the old curling tongs up the ass when having the piss.
Right. So I can't even be bothered.
No, go on, we're interested. We're interested. Why, Doc? Come on, we're interested. Don't
you can't be bothered. You get Mondays off. Do some work.
Right. So anyway, so the doctor says, "Oh, it's not looking good. We'll have to set that off."
Mm. What? He's like, a novectomy.
Yeah.
Really.
But the funny thing is, right?
Nothing funny about that.
They've done, you're doing me head in. You're
doing Just tell the story!
He's doing me head in.
Oh, you can chill out on Monday.
I've only got 15 minutes, but I'm gonna talk to you every Saturday. I'm gonna get the money's worth out of this, because you get Mondays off. And I can't bear the fact someone's getting away with something like that, because it's terrible. So you're gonna stick this out, or you're gonna have to work Mondays. So take it on the chin, right? Okay.
Just finish the story.
Yes.
I command you.
Just do it.
Anyway, so they've said, he said, you know, will you be able to sort me a little knob out?
A prosthetic cock, yeah.
Yeah. But they put him out for the operation.
Yep.
He woke up.
Yep.
Right, and he's thinking, oh, thank God that's over and done with.
Yeah.
They've only grown it on his arm.
What are you talking about? You twat. Shut the f- you're an idiot. What do you mean they've grown it on his arm?
Apparently, like, that's the way they do it.
Oh, yeah, but to then put it on, that wasn't a mistake. It wasn't Dr. Graham, did it go there? Some bloke didn't, I didn't do a degree.
Are you a real doctor?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but why put it there?
Because it's got a graft, because it's got to grow, it's got a graft there, it's where they can control it. To skin, the skin tissue.
But on your arm.
Well.
But they're going to remove it from the arm itself. What do you mean on the back?
On your back.
Somewhere, well, we can't wear a T-shirt.
Yeah, but you could
he's in hospital!
This way, you can still have a little tug, can't he?
But they'll leave it there for quite a bit. It's not... Do you know what I mean? It's not going to be like, oh, it's just there for a few days.
Yeah.
It's there for a bit. That's not good, is it?
So he's got a cock on his arm?
Yeah. What's up with that?
What do you mean, what's up with that?
Well, I mean, you could say it's a thumb or something, couldn't he? Yeah.
But they remove it.
Be good for hitching.
Below later.
If you had a knob instead of a thumb and you went hitchhiking, just tickle it, and they can see it like a mile down the road, couldn't they?
Boasting.
Yeah. If I'd lost my knob, I'd go, oh, I'm not going to have all that stuff. Just whack a pair of tits on me. Do you know what I mean? I think, oh, I'll have a, just forget it.
But why not just put it where it should be straight away instead of messing about?
Where should it be straight away?
You know.
On the forehead.
Listen, are we doing a competition?
Let's play a tune.
You can't be bothered. Right, okay, we're going to scrap this and you're going to work Mondays again.
Shut up. What are we talking? What are we doing? I've got something to tell you, actually. You know we teased Steve about, not ever spending any money?
Careful, I'm careful with money, I'm not-
Yeah? Guess what? He's treating it like, he's nurturing this, right? He keeps running off, right, in the edit. He's having a suit made, and he wants it to be just right, because I reckon he's forking out quite a lot. He's having a suit made. Think of that. Him.
Let me tell you this, though. I don't want you thinking that I'm getting all flash with my cash. It's very hard to buy off the peg when you're 6'7". So, you know, it was a necessity. Carl, I don't want you thinking that this is the beginning of some new phase.
Well, is everything you buy sort of made to measure, or...?
No, I'm afraid if only I could afford it, mate. But, no, I'm off the peg, generally, but...
So what, like, properly done and that, just...
Oh, yeah, it's the full thing. The full works. Got to keep going back for fittings, they got that little bit of chalk, you know, the pins.
It's where I had mine made, you know how good I look all the time.
Did you have to have that, thing done where they say, what side do you wear your member?
What side you dress? They don't say what side you wear your member. That would hardly be a euphemism, would it? So they say, what side do you dress, sir? It means what side your little poke, your little John Thomas leans, doesn't it, on rest, usually to the left, isn't it? Your little left testicles.
If I said to you now, what side do you wear it on? Do you know?
It would be left. It would be the left. That's what I mean. If standing there, right, with nothing restricting it or holding it in or holding it up, right, it sort of leans, your one ball is sort of like slightly back and lower, isn't it? And your little John Thomas rests there, so it's left. And the reason they ask it is so they don't put the tape measure up on the left and squash your willy or touch your willy.
So it's nothing to do with, like, well, you'll need a bit more room of sort of more material on that side, or...?
Well, no, I don't think they compensate. It's just when they put the... when they stick that up into your groin, they don't want to come in contact with, with your
the thing is, I don't know what side I wear stuff on. I just sort of pull my pants up and wherever it wants to go that day.
But maybe it's not big enough to sort of make any, you know, real decision.
But, like now, I'm sat here, right, with my jeans on. I don't know where I am.
Well, that's clear from hearing you talk.
No, but what I mean is, if a fella said to me, what side are you, you know, what side's your member on?
Member? What is this the use of the word member suddenly?
Well,
it's usually not appropriate, and also, I imagine in the old days they have big baggy pants and used to sort of like hang down, and now, you know, like with those stretchy boxers and briefs, it's sort of held up in a nice little, neat little parcel, isn't it? So it's probably not appropriate, it doesn't come in contact with your little snake. So, you know. Are you telling me a tailor has asked you that and you went, what do you mean, mate?
No, I've never, I've not really had one made to measure. I had one made when I was a kid, but since then I've sort of bought a suit off the hook. But when you were saying about buying a suit, I know that question sort of crops up and I don't know what the answer is. It just annoys me the way there's no surprises anymore. Do you know what I mean? People know.
What do you mean? He's gonna go, right, I'm gonna measure you now. Which side shall I measure? Go, well, pot luck, go on, have a look. Right, there you go. Oh, you got it.
There's no surprises anymore? What are you talking about?
Everything you say is a surprise. Every opinion you have is a surprise to me.
What I mean is, why aren't people just happy just to go, well, depends, doesn't it? I'll just pull the pants up wherever it wants to go, I'm happy.
What do you mean? Why is this such a big issue?
But Carl, when they ask you this question, they're not making a note of it somewhere. It's not statistical research to find out what the kind of common leaning is. It's just, it's a question so he doesn't touch it when he's using his tape measure.
Just be careful.
But he is being careful by asking the question.
But what's wrong with him touching it anyway? It's only a slight.
Fair enough.
But if he just sort of, you know, knocks it a little bit, you can just go.
Do that again?
To me, it's the same as the prostate thing. It's just happening all over again.
But the doctor doesn't go, oh, what side's your arse on, sir? Trying to avoid the arse. He wants to go, he knows where your arse is and he's aiming for it and he wants to get it up there. He's aiming for it for a good cause. This little fella's going, well, I've got to measure his leg. I don't want to touch the knob. I'll just ask him, sir, do you mind telling me where your cock is so I can avoid it? It's a big difference.
But like I'm saying to you, I'd have to have a look first. To let him know. I don't know where it is now. I don't know, it could be the left, could be the right.
Are you telling me you don't know where your knob is
without
now?
Looking.
How would you mean without looking?
Well, you're saying it as if like-
Should we have a guess?
Well, have a look and tell us where it is.
And what are you wearing? What sort of pants are you wearing?
I've got my jeans on.
But you've got pants on underneath them?
Yeah.
What are they? Briefs? Or boxer shorts?
Boxer shorts.
Boxer shorts. Well, it's probably free, but the jeans are probably stricken it. I think it's probably either in the middle, resting, or just slightly to the left. Have a look, and we'll tell the listeners after the break, where's Carl's knob? It's a good competition.
Oh, brilliant. We've got to send this to the Sony Awards people.
Well, big question. Where was, Carl's knob?
That's what people have been hanging on for.
Yeah. Where was it?
Well, I can't believe people have been texting in.
Hey, well, guessing where it is.
People saying, is it in the middle? Is it in the left? Cost them 10p. Cost them 10p to find out. Just wait, I'm gonna get out the answer. You don't win anything, right? Like, strike it lucky. Right,
bottom or middle? Right.
It was to the left.
Oh!
Yeah.
I went with the right. That's annoying.
See, I thought it would be to the left. If not, maybe if it was all scrunched up, sitting down on your lap, right, it might just pop up to the middle. Just pop out. Like, you know.
Well, next week we'll be finding out where yours is.
Where's Ricky's bollocks?
Right then, which leads us nicely into
Knob News.
Oh, it's the welcome return of Knob News.
Right, okay, it's very much like the news at 10, this, isn't it? Mm. I do a bong, or in this case a schlong, and he gives me the headlines, the Knob News of the day. The big, where have you collected all this Knob News? Was there a lot of Knob News this week?
It was mental this week. The amount of stuff. The way it works, you give us the bong, yeah. I'll give you the headline.
Okay.
Steve decides which stories we're going to talk about.
And now on XFM, Knob News. Schlong.
Man grows knob on his arm.
Schlong.
Man gets doctors to make him a second knob.
Schlong.
Turkish prisoners made hole in cell wall to produce third inmate.
Schlong.
doctors accidentally remove man's testicles.
So, well, can I straight away go for the accidental removal of the testicles?
Well, it's happened before, hasn't it? We've talked about that before.
Well, how does it, oh, what did he go in? For a tonsillitis, what are they called? Tonsillectomy? And he went in the wrong way. What are you talking about? How can they accidentally remove his testicles?
It says, he didn't look at his folder, and the doctor said to the fella, oh, we've removed your testicles and we wanted to take out your prostate gland. So, that's what happened there. There's the story. This is what I mean, that's why I don't like going to the doctors.
Yes!
It happens, doesn't it? Because all these sort of, it's when they say things like, oh, it's just, we do loads of these operations. That's when they're not concentrating.
Brilliant.
Do you know what I mean? When they say it's procedure. That's like having a boring job that you do every day when you're not going to be concentrating. I prefer them to go, this is a tricky one, this.
I know what you mean! I sort of do know what you mean!
People, you watch TV programs about, like, you know, removing someone's second head or whatever, and he's like the best surgeons from all over the world.
It's televised, they can't make a mistake. They can't go, we took his legs off by mistake.
Whereas the fella who's having a prostate, it's like, oh, do you want to do it? I'm sick of doing them. Yeah. And they're probably doing a crossword whilst writing it.
Of course they are. I've seen that actually in operating theatres. They're doing a crossword.
That's what I mean.
Yeah.
I was just examining some of the other knob news, Rick, a little bit more closely. Mm. Man gets doctors to make him a second penis. I'm sure we're all interested in what happened there. Yeah. A German who persuaded doctors to give him a second penis has lost his wife after he showed her the result. Biker Michael Gruber lost his original penis in a motorbike accident, and doctors built him a second one using a mixture of skin, bone, and other tissues.
Bone?
Apparently, the penis worked so well that he was even able to father a child with his wife Bianca. But Gruber was still not happy and asked doctors to repeat the operation and build him a better organ, to which they agreed. From his hospital bed, he said, I've got two penises, but no wife. I'm hoping when I get rid of one of the penises, I'll get her back.
What do you mean? So he had two put on?
What side does he wear?
So he's had both. So he's had three, then?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
This is probably the thing that happened with Hitler, when he had one ball, but he had three at one point, didn't he? So he just got one in the other ball, gave his mum one, and got the other one.
Man grows penis on his arm. I mean, why people are constantly losing their penises around the world? I've no idea.
But why on
the
arm?
What do you mean, why on the arm? It's just a graft, isn't it?
Yeah, but put it on, like, your buttock or your side. Not, you can't wear a short-sleeved shirt. Why do they've done that before. I don't understand it. Why not just graph it onto the side of your leg or something where it's high up, close to where it should be?
I don't know! To get it used to the environment. Like when you were like released a duck into the wild.
I've never understood that. If there's a doctor, again, you know, we had a doctor last time, this is someone who can let us know why they put it on the arm.
So they can keep an eye on it, presumably. He's not going to work with this knob on his arm. He's probably in a hospital bed and under examination.
Right.
So, what do you think? They pop the knob on the arm, say, come back in 3 weeks. What do you do, by the way? I'm a mechanic. Keep the long sleeve shirt, because the blokes will go, why have you got a knob on your arm, mate? What are you talking about? He doesn't go back to normal as a teacher. Sir, what is it, Simpkins? You got a knob on your arm. No, don't worry about that. Do your maths. What do you think this bloke's walking around with a big knob coming out of his arm?
Why on the arm?
So they can keep an eye on it. So it's not
but if he's in bed, just get him to not put any undies on or whatever and just have a little sly look at how it's going. Even in hospital, if you're in a shared, like, little hospital room, people going, oh, I've had heart problems, what's your problem? He's there with his arm out.
He's got his knob out! Yeah, but I don't think it counts as indecent exposure when they're grafting a knob on your arm, sticking that out of the bed!
Imagine if he's driving, he's just got it out the window. People driving by.
Yeah. Like the fact that at the end of is that bloke giving me the finger?
Yeah, at the end of the man grows penis on his arm story, it says, a Moscow surgeon said the man will be able to have sex in a few months. He said, women will never suspect. But what kind of a doctor talks like that?
Yeah.
I don't really, is this cock now, seriously. The birds will never know. He'll be able to go berserk.
Yeah.
They'll never realise he grew up on his arm.
That is unbelievable. Will he have a little scar on his arm, do you think?
Yeah, I don't get it. Like I say, 83936 if there's a doctor out there.
Or indeed if you've ever grown
or a tailor. Making you a shirt. What side do you wear your cock on, sir? It's on my left arm. I think, the listening public would have enjoyed knob news there.
Oh. So,
I mean, there was a lot of knob news this week.
I was surprised. You know, I would have thought it would be hard sometimes to get knob news together, but
I would have thought it would have been part of a bigger news programme, but I mean, I don't think we'd dedicate a whole sort of, you know, like John Craven's news round.
Yeah.
A whole 5 minutes to knob-related news.
Yeah.
It was, there was other news, was there, in the week at all? Carl, it wasn't just all knob-related, you didn't just research.
No, they're the ones that sort of stand out. there was Christ on a crisp.
Right, what's that? That's obviously a crisp that someone vaguely thinks looks a bit like Robert Powell.
Yeah.
Yeah, what a load of twaddle, yeah.
There was a bloke who can, blow up balloons using his ears.
What do you mean?
Look at him.
Just, well, it's all connected, isn't it? That's, you know, you're just redirecting it, aren't you?
Pointless, I mean, though, isn't it?
It is pointless. No, I'm sort of downplaying it like it's no big deal, but it is pretty impressive.
It's not. When was the last time you blew up a balloon?
Oh, I don't know.
That's what I mean. It's not needed. It's not impressive. That's what I mean. That's what.
But you can say that about any form of sort of like bizarre entertainment. I don't think you have to hang yourself from hooks. But a lot of people go and see Jim Rowe Circus. I mean, I wouldn't. I don't see the.
But would you go and see that?
What, a man blowing up balloons? No. If it was a mate of mine, I'd go do that thing you can do. To a group of new friends, I'd go, right, then I'd get on with it. You know, to me it's below an average card trick doing something like that.
Apparently, though, he does make balloon animals with his penis, so,
which is pretty good, isn't it?
Up with his ears, so.
It's always a snake. It's not a snake. I go, yeah, well done. Back
to the news. Okay, right, this is one I'm throwing right at you as well, Carl. There's only one bird that has a penis.
It's not a joke.
It's not a joke. This is a genuine trivia question.
I'd say... Oh. I'll say... I think I've seen one on this. Is it an ostrich?
Right, you're going for ostrich, Carl.
I'll go for ostrich as well.
Right. Did you come up with that yourself, or?
Yeah, I was going to say that before you said it.
Well, guys, you went for ostrich.
Chicken?
You're both wrong. It's actually the swan.
The chicken.
Yeah.
What? That's a bit worrying then, because I thought I saw an ostrich penis, so what was I looking at?
I don't know, were you just examining it closely at the zoo?
No, I was just...
It was probably a strap-on.
It was probably two leather ostriches giving each other one.
Exactly.
And I just, and that's how that can influence people, things like that. Dirty, filthy leather ostriches can
confuse a child if he's at the zoo and he doesn't know.
A swan's got on, that's really annoying. I'd never give a swan a knob.
Mm.
It's the little puffiest of all
birds. It is the
puffiest
of all birds,
isn't it?
Yes.
All protected by the queen. Mm. But I need a knob. If I had to give a knob to any bird,
good question.
No, I wish
I'd posed that myself. If you could give a knob to any bird, what would it be? Phone in.
Vulture.
Well, of course a vulture.
That, yeah. They need a big, veiny bang stick. Yeah.
What about yourself, Carl, if you could give a knob to any bird? And don't make it rude, or if I could give a knob to any bird,
what
I'd
bird
make it
What bird do you see with It's got to be a bird of prey or something like that, hasn't it? Cool.
Just a robin, really.
That would be amazing.
Christmas cards would be like.
but it's a normal human-sized knob on a robin. That'd be great, wouldn't it?
That'd be genius.
The other thing annoying about this is ironic, right? Now, the male of all bird species are usually they're called a cock.
Yes.
Right. But the only bird with a cock.
Yeah.
Right, is called a cob.
Is that what a swan's called?
Yeah, they're cob and pen. They're not cock and hen.
That's annoying.
And he's got a. He isn't a cock, but he's got a cock.
Yeah. Yeah. Quick query there, Rick.
Go on.
When you said then cock,
yeah.
Presumably you meant male bird
yeah.
the first time you said it.
Yeah.
The second time you said it, you said cock. Did you mean the penis?
Well, you're showing off the whole farce of radio broadcasting.
Because you're not really allowed to say cock.
No, exactly.
Penis.
No. One cock would cause great offence.
Yeah.
The other cock's fine.
Exactly.
It's weird, isn't it?
It is strange. It is strange. So, I mean, if I said now to you, you know, oh, I like cocks.
Yeah.
Meaning birds.
Yeah, that's
fine. That'd be fine.
Yeah.
But if I meant penises, it would be a problem.
If you like cocks, it was penis. Yeah, that would be-
Carl, do you like cocks? Do you like cocks?
No.
Right, okay, that's fine. I was asking if you like-
No, I like, you know.
Yeah. Well, I'm a big fan of, tits.
The small birds that come down and peck at you.
Yeah.
Yeah, you like tits and cocks. There's nothing-
Tits and cocks.
There's nothing wrong with- Carl, don't worry. There's nothing wrong with saying tits and cocks.
When I said tits, I meant the little birds.
Yeah,
when I said cocks, I mean the big birds.
Yeah. Do you know, when,
go on.
No, it's just that, it's when you're talking about tits.
Yeah.
You know, at the milk. I like the fact they flutter away when they hear the milkman coming.
Oh, come on.
So when-
What?
What are you talking about? No, when the milkman's coming, when he's walking up-
Got to apologise to our producer there, because he was worried about him a bit. There was nothing wrong with it. It's just like saying, you what, you know, you like watching birds in the garden.
It's just that I think you're better than that.
I know, it's cheap, isn't it, to say, like, we like
tits. I like tits.
Yeah, I like cocks. So, are we a bit more literary now? One of my favourite things is Fanny by Gaslight.
Really? That's interesting. That's interesting. I'm a big fan of Moby Dick.
Oh, the the book, Moby Dick. Not the medical condition. There's nothing in your it's the big horrible thing that used to swallow semen.
Yeah.
Now, in the winter, Steve.
Go on.
There's nothing I like more than to keep my hands warm in a muff.
No, sure. You mean those kind of furry things that sort of classy looking ladies?
Yeah, posh ladies often put their hands in. Yeah, you know when you go have a nice, like, a party and they're leaving?
Yeah, a winter party.
And you might take the wrong hat or something. There's nothing I like more than to see two posh women with their hands in each other's muffs.
Oh, that's always a
funny. And they're going, oh, this must be yours.
Yeah, that is always funny.
Yeah.
That's always funny.
Yeah. But seriously, no, I'll start this, you're right, I've got a degree.
I just remembered that my favourite Beatles song is Come Together.
Yeah. Now, we're gonna stop this now, Carl, because it's childish. You're right, I've got a philosophy degree, for Christ's sake, and it's about time.
Who's your favourite philosopher? Do you mind me asking?
Well, I would tell you, except when I ever talk about it, I go into a Cockney accent.
Really?
So it can be like, my favourite philosopher, I like a bit of Kant.
Right. Is that Immanuel Kant, the philosopher?
Yeah.
That's strange.
Yeah.
That's strange. What's his name again?
Can't.
Oh yeah. That can be weird. Can be strange.
Look at Carl's
face.
Look at his face.
Join in, Carl.
Oh,
undo your trousers.
We'd be like Stan Boardman when he told the Fokker joke.
Yeah.
We won't do local radio again for 10 years. I'm still pissed off that swans have got cocks.
Yeah.
It's a waste. It's a waste of a knob with a swan.
I know what you mean.
They don't know what they're doing with it half the time. Now we've got some great. Do you remember? We're stopped all the silly innuendos now. But do you remember?
I think it's because they've got a long neck, and to balance them properly in the water.
A counterbalance.
What are those things that boats have underneath?
A rudder.
No.
No. Yeah. The keels. Yeah. The big.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
It might be. You might be right. Yeah.
Balance.
What about? But ducks would need one as well, wouldn't they?
Ducks don't.
Because they've got short necks.
Oh, I see what you mean. It's the necks. Yeah.
So hold on. So do you think that's? So, long necks, long knob.
Don't look at me, Gervais.
That's Steve.
I know. No. Sandy Tosfeg's got a tiny cock, hasn't she?
But she has got one, which is interesting.
That's libelous. Yeah. I'd just like to say now that Sandy Tosfeg has never had a knob.
No, she's not.
But you're not lying about the neck.
No, she's got a little neck. That's
little
fine.
Neck,
that's clear for all to see. I just remember a bloke I saw on Opportunity Knocks once.
Opportunity Knocks?
Yeah. It was a pianist, well, it's true, and his name was Wayne King. Do you like Wayne King?
Carl, what's your opinion on Wayne King?
I don't know his work.
You're not a fan of his work? Okay, no, that's fine, Carl. We asked your opinion, mate, and you've given it, and that's all we can ask for.
And it's knob news time. We're all very excited. Now, last week's knob news was what, Carl? Do you remember it was a man
who grew a knob on his arm?
Sure.
No, he didn't grow it there, did he? They put it there.
Well, I know that, but... Yeah.
Just popped it on his arm.
Yeah.
This
week. Let's just recap of the week's news. Right now is the headlines.
Well, we talked about it before. Do you know the little mouse that had an ear on its back?
Yeah.
Sure.
Right. Well, you thought he had a bad time, right? Listen to this one. Mouse walking about with us sort of wearing a monkey's testicle. Just having a laugh. This is what I mean about a lot of scientists. What are they doing? When's that going to come in handy?
I don't know what you mean.
Well, they were seeing if, you know, say if a fella loses one, right?
Yeah.
Hitler or whatever. And they go, well, don't worry about it. We can sort you out. I don't know what the monkey's going to do. Not if they keep passing them on or whatever. But the actual monkey testicle was put on the mouse. And it worked. It worked for the mouse.
But isn't it, I mean, isn't a monkey's testicle quite large in relation to a mouse? Would it not look like the mouse was on a space hopper or something?
Oh yeah, it didn't look good.
Well, they didn't put it where its testicles would be.
No, they did.
But they put it, well, how could it walk then? The ear was on his back, so he could just get about.
Well, I don't know, but
well, you don't know, do you? You just guessed. Did they grow the monkey's testicles where the mouse testicles would-
Well, it looked stupid anywhere else, though, wouldn't it?
Oh, whereas a mouse with monkey testicles, that's fine.
Oh, you'd be showing off. You'd be alright. I'd prefer that than the ear.
When that mouse gets put back in with the other mice, do the other mice go, George, you look different. Have you had anything done?
But the weird thing is, as well, apparently it still works as a monkey.
What? So, like, what are you talking about?
Like the, you know, the sperm and that was, it was still sort of monkey.
Of course it was. What are you talking about?
But that's weird.
But, it's only a thing to give it nutrients. That's all the thing they're testing. It's like grafting at that level. Right, what's your question? Because right. What do you think? It would change eventually, it would have changed into a mouse testicle, because it had been hanging round a mouse for so long.
No, I thought the actual sperm of it, though, would be a mouse's.
Why?
Because it's hanging off a mouse.
No, but your sperm is actually created in the testicles.
That's why it has
to be outside your body, otherwise we put them in a nice little cage.
I'm guessing then that they've done this operation so that they can do it to humans. Yeah? Why would I want a monkey testicle if my kids are gonna be monkeys? What use is it?
No, think. But think. Think of what you're saying. They've grown a monkey testicle on a mouse to see if it would still function as a monkey's testicle, okay? So they can do that to humans. So think, Carl. What they'd do is, they'd grow a human testicle on a mouse, and it could still be used as a human testicle.
So what?
To give you a testicle that you've lost.
From a mouse?
No, from another person who it was kept alive on a mouse. Because it's kept the nutrients alive, as opposed to keeping it a deep freeze. Maybe bollocks go off after a week. I don't know. Maybe they get accidents. He had a little card. Do you donate your testicles yet? I'll tell you what. No one needs testicles yet. Let's keep them on a mouse. You have yours ripped off in some sort of bizarre skiing accident. You go, well, you're in a Battersea dog town. You pick the ones you want. They can grow them on anything. They can grow them on a Dachshund. Bulldogs are growing them usually. That's where you see a bulldog. Usually that's waiting for an operator. What don't you understand, Carl?
Hang on a minute. I thought this was knob news, not testicle time. I don't understand what
it is. Testicle time's not for another 10 minutes.
Yeah.
No, it's all sort of it linked and that, though, isn't it?
Well, sometimes it's linked to a mouse.
But do you, I mean, what do you think about, like, I don't know, testing stuff out like that? Is it worth it? Could you not just go straight from...
But listen, Carl, I'm getting this information from you.
No, it's
if this
it's
was
right.
on Question Time and someone said, you know, Dimbleby and Paxman or whoever said it, I'd think about it as a moral dilemma. You've just said you saw a mouse with a monkey testicle. What do you think of that? I don't think any of it. I don't think anything of it is the answer, Carl, because I can't trust the info. I cannot trust anything that comes out of your mouth.
Well, it's true, but it's just all this, it's the same thing, isn't it? It's the leeches in a blender, it's the fella looking at an electron.
Yeah.
It's the mouse with an ear on its back.
Yeah.
I don't know what the point is.
But you don't read on. Because I've seen you read some, and you're going, look at that, man survives on eating knee. And I go, what else? You go, I didn't read on.
You look at the mouse with the ear on the back, and you just think, that must be murder at a concert. Is it worth
You think he swallowed someone's ear? He gnawed it away and swallowed it, and it's just in his system.
Yeah.
No, I just get a bit sad about the mice. And
I agree. I mean, that is sad. Yeah. Of course, anything like that. Yeah. You know, when you came round the other night, before you came round, I'm sitting there just at the computer. It's a hot day, wasn't it? As you know, I was in my shorts. I was tucked in. I didn't get them out till you came round. Just my own business. Jane got some wax strips, and she went, oh, let me just do your back. I went, no. I haven't got a hairy back. I've got a couple of wispy hairs on my shoulders, probably about 20 either side. Nothing to worry about. It's not like I look one of those people that's like a gorilla on the beach.
I assume your back looks a little bit like Carl's head.
Exactly, yeah. And she went, let me just do this. I went, no, she put it on my back, and she ripped it off. I went, forget it. She went, I've got to do the other side now. I said, forget it. I let it to the other side. It's ridiculous. It's so painful. And I've hardly got any hairs on the back, right? So, it made me think of something that I'd heard about. There's a thing that you can do, and I don't know why, for people with really hairy backs and people who are hairy all over, okay, called back crack and sack. They do your back, and there's some people that do look like little monkeys.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
They do your back, they do your ass crack, and they do your balls.
Oh.
In that order.
Oh, that again! Always a question that doesn't matter.
No, it does, because what I'm saying is it done from the top all the way down?
It's not done in one! What do you think? This is huge 30-foot band-aid type thing that you're wrapped in and then pulled. It's done a little bit at a time, isn't it?
Right, well, again, it still matters which order. Because if it hurts your back, it's definitely going to hurt the sack. That's what I'm saying. I think... What is it called? Back...
Crack and sack.
Or sack, crack and back?
No, it's called back, crack... I don't know. It's probably a marketing person telling we've got to put it in order.
You could probably choose which order you want them in, Clark.
It's back, crack and sack.
It should be sack. Sack, crack, back. Definitely. It should be sold like that.
Why?
Because like I say, if you're lying there, look, you've had half of your back done. If you went, oh, forget it, right, there is no way you're going to have the sack done. Is it?
No. I'm sorry, I wouldn't have the crack and sack done anyway.
I don't know why people
I'm not
going
to have a back done. It doesn't need doing.
Where are people going where they've got to worry about the condition of the sack? At what event do you go to and you go, well, I've got to look sharp. I've got to look the part today.
I don't know.
On the sack belt.
Nudists?
No, because they're about being natural and that, isn't it? Normally they are airy, like that woman on holiday.
Yeah, the women are, the men aren't. No, I don't know.
Yeah, they all are sort of pretty airy. They believe in just leaving the body as it is.
I think little gay fellas like love it, don't they?
Why are you looking at me? I don't know.
I don't know. If you're a little gay fella and you've had it done.
Yeah,
Just text in. What's the text thing?
83XFM. Just text in. You know, tell us what. I don't know. Do we need? Is there any information that we're missing? Is it painful? I assume so.
Of course it is.
Why did you get it done? That's the question. Why did you get it done?
Yeah,
why is it important to have a hairless arse?
eating knobs.
Yeah.
Jilly Goulden. Now she.
What's she been up to?
Well, you saw it in I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here.
I haven't been watching it.
She popped a little kangaroo knob in the mouth, chewed it up.
What, she just found it? Did she lying around?
No, it was one of the things that she had to
eat. Oh, it was one of the challenges.
Carol Thatcher, you know, a daughter of one of our leaders.
Sure.
She popped a couple of bollocks in the mouth, chewed them up, swallowed them.
Oh.
And Jilly Goulden, there was a kangaroo penis there, dried. She couldn't even get, it was so tough she couldn't even get through it. And then she, eventually she eats it.
What, was it like a pepperoni?
Yeah. And she chewed, what do you think of that, Carl?
What, eating that sort of stuff?
Yeah.
I watch it. I like those little trial bits, right?
Yeah.
But what I don't think people realise is, right, it is hard eating a little kangaroo knob. Right?
Really? How do you know?
No, it's just, you know, you think about it and you go, oh, I couldn't do that, right? But what they never mention on the TV programme, which I think takes it to the next level, right, they're eating that at, like, 7:30 in the morning.
Sure. Right.
Which is worse, innit?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? If I was there and Ant and Dec said, right, Carl, eat the knob, I'd go, hang on a minute, give us a few hours, let me get some rice and that on my belly and just sort of fill me up a little bit more. I'll pop back at about 6:30 this evening.
Right.
Have it ready. And I'd be happier then. It's just that thing of, you know,
you don't want to eat animal genitals on an empty stomach.
So what are you saying?
I could eat a knob at night, but...
Just cut that there. We'll loop that. If any DJs are listening, no. Just take that quote, I could eat a knob at night, by Carl Pilkington. No. Maybe do a dance remix.
Yeah, maybe you're sort of a house producer and you could maybe get some kind of high energy beat going and then we could send that out to some of the gay clubs. I'm sure it'd be really popular.
Please anyone send us, you know, that looped with a nice little, you know, funky house beat. Carl Pilkington saying I could eat a knob at night.
No, but do you know what I mean though? By that.
Not really.
Well, okay then, right. Okay. Now, I couldn't do it. I could not do it. I couldn't pop a kangaroo testicle in my mouth and chew it. It was disgusting to watch. She was eating witchetty grubs. I mean, good on them because they were doing it. But then again, I think, well, they wanted to go in there. They knew they were up for it. So on the one hand, I think, is that admirable and is that showing sort of like good British metal? Or is it, you know, I'll do anything to get on telly for a week? I don't know. You know what I mean? I don't, where does it stop? You know, I thought Rebecca Lewes went too far when she gave the little pig a tug, but at least she knew where to stop. Yeah. She didn't, you know.
Well, Jenny, it's obvious when you have to stop.
Yeah, but you know,
the pig tells you that.
To pop the can. Also, again, where's the kangaroo hopping around without a cock?
Yeah, it's just that, you know, you had the girls in and that, and it reminded me I was talking to Steve in a week.
Yeah.
I think it's, when people were talking about going to string fellas and that.
Yeah.
I was talking about seeing naked people.
Ah, no, yes, I asked him, I said, when he used to watch, say, if he accidentally flipped onto BBC Two and some ballet was on, would his eye ever been drawn to maybe the gentleman's lower regions rather than the ladies?
The gentleman's package?
Yeah, would your eyes ever be accidentally drawn to that and you couldn't resist it? And you, you said yes.
Yeah, because, right, oh, I don't think I'm,
Oh dear.
Well, go on, I mean, fair enough.
No, right.
I'm always looking at the beautiful ladies, but fair enough.
Yeah.
No, go on.
But, right,
have you ever looked at Wayne Sleep's testicles?
I went out.
Have you ever looked at Wayne Sleep's penis and testicles?
I went out on a night out, right? And it was some, it got to some point in the night where two women and two fellas got on the stage.
Right.
Right? Started stripping off.
Yes.
Yeah. Just, yeah. What, members of the audience?
No, I think they were, like, part of the act, right?
Right.
And,
what was this, panto?
They downed the, you know, the fellas were, had, like, their undies on, and the girls just had their knickers on.
Yes.
Right? And,
sounds pretty erotic at the moment. Go on.
And at the same time, they all whipped their pants off.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah. It was Spucks Fizz, wasn't it? The the adult show.
Now, I said to Steve, at that point...
Sorry, I wasn't there. He said it to me later.
Yeah.
I said, well, you have a quick glance at the fellas. And then the annoying thing was, you sort of, I thought, right, now I'll have a look at the women, and it was too late, they put the knickers on.
How long were you looking at the fellas?
Not that long, but
it why was were you looking at them first?
It's human nature, isn't it?
Why?
I don't know, but I'm sure you would have done the same thing. You just sort of think, well, how are they shaping up?
So it's a comparative test.
So what was the who had the biggest knob? Which one of the blokes had the biggest knob?
No, it's like, you know, normal. But
this is a whole new side of you.
This is a whole other area.
So you look at ballet dancers, you look at the gentlemen's.
No, I don't. Package. I just was when he said this, it reminded me of this night when I was walking home thinking, oh.
Oh.
didn't get a look. Because I was
messing around. Where was this? What event was this where people are stripping off?
Carl, I tell you what, you are the most interesting man I have ever met.
But are you comfortable being nude and that?
We've done this. Well, I don't know what this is. We did this last week about, are you comfortable being nude?
No, I know, I was talking
about
you're
probably
that.
Most comfortable being nude, it's just probably not in public.
Mm. Well, Ricky's only really comfortable nude when he's eating.
Yeah, there's nothing to get, you know.
Yeah, you can just wipe yourself down.
Yeah, you just sit in the bath, yeah.
No, but I've talked about that, and then when I went home, I was talking to Suzanne about it, and she said, what's all that about? You don't like being nude, right? And I said, well, it's not.
It's like I'm part of an Alan Bennett play. It's just, I love the way you talk.
Remember once, right, I don't know if I should talk about this, really, but...
Well, that means you should, so go on.
Go on.
Yeah. Right, we went to Tenerife, right, one year. Okay. And I was still living in Manchester.
I'm scared now. Yeah, I'm actually scared.
I'm thinking about Suzanne, but she's
well, I don't want to know anything about Suzanne,
come
to
on,
be honest.
No, but come on,
it involves me more.
Go on, story. Go on.
But I'm just explaining to you that I don't like being nude.
Mm. Yes. Go on. So you're in Tenerife?
In Tenerife, right. Didn't have much money. Stayed in this apartment that wasn't that nice, right. Had cockroaches in it and stuff, right. Yeah. Didn't have much money to go out at night. So we're in this sort of death trap of an apartment, right?
Uh-huh.
Anyway, so when I was younger, right, had a bit more energy. So
he's 30. 80, I know.
So, you know, start having it away a bit.
It's a joy.
Beautiful.
It's
so,
gone,
yeah.
I've been here to work, I love it, go on.
Right. So, you know, doing what I do, right?
Yeah.
Someone starts banging on the door. So
everyone's at it. Right, so you mean knocking on the door, right, okay.
Yeah. Knocking on the door, right. So Suzanne said, you better get it. So I said, oh, I can't get it now, can I? I'll have to wait a bit. Right. I can't go to the door.
Go on.
So the banging's getting louder.
Yeah.
Someone at the door.
Yeah.
And she's like, oh, no, but it must be important. I'm like, in a minute. Just, so anyway.
In a minute. I don't want to know anymore.
Keep going. No, come on, finish the story.
open the door, it's a fireman, so I just stick my head round, and he's going, you'll have to get out, the building's on fire, right? So I'm like, in a minute.
Sorry, you weren't still having sex at this point?
No, no, but, you know, right. Still sort of got to wait a minute or I can't get my pants on.
Oh, Carl, I wish I'd I'm so sorry.
Right, go on. So, the place is burning down.
So, it could be a serious big fire going on.
Yeah.
I'm sort of waiting. You can hear people sort of screaming and that, panicking.
Yeah. Is that because the door's open and you're nude?
The fireman's saying, will you get out, will you get out? I'm saying, in a minute.
Right.
And Suzanne was saying, you know, think of something that's not sexy.
Sure.
So I was thinking of people, you know, thinking maybe dying in a fire might sort of calm you down.
Yeah.
Then the fireman said, we need a big pole.
Yeah. Yeah, sure, go on.
But what I'm saying is, that, to me, I wouldn't have wanted to go out and be safe over, do you know what I mean, over being naked. I don't like walking about without on. So what I'm saying is, even if that fire...
I love the idea of everyone huddled in there with the other firemen. It just, the camera's fans long and it's Carl.
Yeah, a local news report.
Naked. With still
but would
standing
you,
proud.
Would you have gone out, we're now on.
But why do I have to go out with now on? I'll just grab a pair of jeans.
Alright, but you've just, you know...
What?
There's a fire, Carl!
Yeah, but
see, no, not everyone looks at men's packets. That's only you, remember. Most of the other firemen wouldn't be going, oh, look at him.
But what I'm interested in is
he's pleased to see us.
Carl, how long did it take, and did the thought of dying in a fire help?
After a bit, but the fireman sort of had a go at me.
Sure.
What do you mean?
Well, like, he wasn't happy that I was dawdling.
Well, to be fair...
But what can you do?
Answers on a postcard! To the usual address. And it is fairly interesting what he sent in. He's found this on the web. I don't know why he's felt an affinity with this particular inventor. But anyway, there's a man, a Serbian man, who has invented a sex machine for women. And he's appealing to Western women to test his device.
Mm.
He's from a town in, as I say, in Serbia. I guess Serbia? I guess that's right. Is that right?
Well, I don't know. What does it say?
Well, it says a Serbian man, but is it called Serbia?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What was all the Croatia-Serbia thing?
Well, it doesn't matter now, does it?
Okay. It doesn't matter now. It does to them. Otherwise they fought for nothing. What the hell do we know about world events? I mean, how long did that go on for? Months,
I don't know.
Wasn't it?
If they're inventing new countries, they can't expect me to keep up with current trends, can we?
Anyway, this Serbian man has invented a sex machine for women, and he can't find any Serbian women to try it out, so he's looking now for Western women. He's taken out a patent on the ultimate sex machine. It runs on a 390-volt electric engine, simulates sex, and has a 7.5-inch artificial penis. He said, my sex machine has an artificial penis that can make up to 180 moves in a minute. Now, I don't even know what that means. 180 moves? What? I mean, there's only really...
Well, in and out,
it's
I imagine.
It's largely
yeah.
the function. Unless what, I've been doing it what wrong, is,
what he's
all
done,
these months.
What he's done is he's put a dildo on a Black and Decker.
A man can only manage the intensity of movement for about 5 seconds normally, but this machine can do it for as long as the woman wants. But anyway, so he's looking for a woman who will test this out. But what I love, as soon as I read this, I was thinking, it's just imagining there going, oh, thanks for coming in, yeah, okay. So there's, what's going to happen is there's a penis that's going to pop out from here, and it's gonna have sex with you. I'm going to stand behind the machine. I've got to stand behind here, there's a lot of dials and stuff, I don't want to bore you in.
Well, why do you have to stand behind it? Just...
I can't, it's technical stuff, but I got to be behind the machine.
But there's no penis on the robot at the moment, it's just
no,
a hole.
No, don't worry, what will happen is, I'll switch the machine on, I'll go behind, and then a penis will appear.
Will it be like a metal-looking penis?
It will be a robotic penis, but it will seem like it's a regular fleshy human penis.
So you're gonna, okay, alright, so you're gonna go behind this robot.
Go behind the machine.
Disappear.
Yep.
And then a fleshy looking penis is
gonna- That will appear.
Through the hole.
When I switch the machine on.
Okay, yeah. And that'll be the real yeah. robotic penis.
But you won't see me for the duration of your sexual
encounter. So you've made this sort of like robotic penis look really realistic.
It's really realistic. You will not be able to tell the difference between, say, the robot one and mine, for instance. You
okay, well I don't want to see yours.
No, there's absolutely not.
Because I've not come around here to have sex with a person.
I know, you've come around to test the machine.
Yeah,
I'm that is exactly what you're gonna get. Okay, mechanical action. But what about is the idea that on the front maybe he's painted a picture of a robot's face.
Yeah.
And then when the machine begins, you know, rather like in one of those horror houses, like a kind of mansion in a spooky film, the eyes of the painting, they'll move.
And the real eyes
will appear. Just staring out. But I don't think I can have sex with this machine unless you're actually in the room, so in case anything goes wrong. No. Don't worry, I'll be behind the machine, it'll be fine. It'll be safe, not a problem.
Okay.
But anyway, so yeah, Paul the Party Animal Parker sent that in, and knowing him, there'll be plenty more coming like that in future weeks.
Carl, what do you think about that? The
machines and that?
Yeah.
Well, they've always been sort of, I mean, to a lot of people, sex is important, isn't it? You know what I mean?
Not to you?
Well, it serves a purpose.
what purpose?
No,
because you don't want to have kids, so what purpose?
Just you know.
Something to do in the evening.
Something to do, isn't it?
When the telly's broke.
But for years, like, they've found stuff, haven't they? Machines from, like, Roman times that similar to that setup.
No machines in Roman times.
Like that, though. The old sort of knob on a stick machine thing.
The old Roman knob on a stick. I'm sorry, but I watch Time Team every week, and Tony Robinson has never done that. An old knob on a stick machine.
I just think of Julius Caesar sitting down and go, okay, Aqueduct, we love that. Yeah. Thanks for that. Straight roads, good idea. We can see the enemy coming. Yeah. What have you got there?
Well, I'm glad you've asked.
Plonkticus. What have you got there? Wanklicus.
What I've got here is a yieldy knob. And I put that on the end of a stick.
Oh, a stick of malice. Okay, well done, Wanklicus.
No.
Well done. Yeah. You are my new right hand man, as they say.
No,
excellent.
But they do stuff like that. You've been in the London Museum and that, and they've got sort of sex stuff from years ago. They've got like these metal pants that they used to wear.
I don't know what that is.
Metal pants.
Yeah, sort of.
Is
metal.
That a chastity belt? You mean they used to make women wear them so that they
when,
can
when,
yeah,
when
no,
when
but they had them for blokes as well though.
Metal pants for blokes. Yeah, why?
So he had a little lot. So if he was away, he couldn't play away from home. And if he was away, she popped on a little.
No, I just think they sort of like sexy metal pants.
Well, I don't know what you mean.
What are you
sexy
talking
metal
about?
Pants.
Well, they'll have to look because they haven't got it in front of me. It's just something I remember seeing, some sort of sexy metal pants that I used to wear.
But what are you saying, sexy metal pants?
Because that was not British Museum. That was Soho.
No, what I mean.
That was Old Compton Street. You were looking at the shop window.
They always had to be ready for like battle and that, but these were a little bit sexy. But protective at the same time.
I love that!
I love the idea that
that's all you remember from the British Museum.
So, Lancelot, are you ready to face the Black Knight? Yeah, just, what do you think of these? Huh? What do you think of these?
Well, I don't really care, just, you know.
I just want to look good on the battlefield.
Well, they're both protective.
Will there be women watching, cheering us on?
Well, you're not going to fight like that, are you? What about with your chest?
I'm going to wear nothing except these sexy metal pants.
But what about your chest is exposed?
No, well, it's a good chest, I'll be working out.
Yeah, I know, but what I mean is you want metal all over. I've actually been
lifting up the round table every week. I just work out, do that about four times a day.
But that machine, right? Why did it have to be a woman, or could they have got a little gay fella in?
I don't know.
Let me just check. it doesn't actually specify the small print here.
I love that. Why do you want to see a little gay fella be...
I don't know. I don't want to see it. I'm just saying they're sort of more...
Why do you want to watch a gay man get buggered by a robot?
I wasn't the one typing in gay machines on the internet, finding stuff out about
it's not a gay machine! You just made it into a gay machine.
Yeah. He wanted to pleasure women with this machine. Oh, you're saying, can I see a little gay fellow get a robotic cock up his arse? You're the one requesting that, Carl Pilkington.
I don't want that. I'm just saying that.
You're the one that wants to see gay men with metal stuff up their anus.
No, what I'm saying is they're more up for a bit more experimentation than...
What are you saying? Why is that the case?
Why? Why did you say that?
No, they're just, you know... Butt plugs and that. I mean, what I'm saying is...
What, you can't just say butt plugs and that.
I'm just saying that I reckon they'd be up for it.
What do you know about butt plugs?
I don't know anything about them. I just remember seeing an advert for some once in a sex shop.
What are you doing?
No, I wasn't. I was just walking past. I was walking past the sex shop and that.
Mm.
And you're sort of looking.
Why were you walking past a sex shop?
Just because I was on the way to work and that, and I passed one, and there was a little sort of... One, it was open early, which I never understood, right? It was about 8 o'clock in the morning, right?
Who's rushing out for butt plugs early in the morning? Who needs them now, right?
Yeah. But I sort of...
I must
of
get a bagel and some poppers on the way to work.
But I walked past it, and it had like a little post-it note, or postcard type thing, and it was like, pop in now, buy an item, chuck in some free butt plugs. And I didn't know what they were for. I'd never heard of them before. But all I'm saying is, I've since found out what they do with them.
And if they do that with them,
then give them a go on that.
I had another email here. This is they haven't given their name actually, but it's an interesting fact. I'm hoping it's true. America's first nudist organisation apparently was founded in 1929 by three men. Now, what intrigued me when I read that is the fact that it's clearly three blokes just trying to meet some nude women.
They're all 52, balding.
Exactly.
With little, so those gold-rimmed glasses.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they're just wandering around, and it's all quite saggy down there, and they're just knocking on doors saying, we've just set up an organisation, it's perfectly above board, completely legitimate, it's a nudist organisation. You got any women in there that want to come and join us? Because we haven't got any female members at the moment. Got any women in there interested in, you know, volleyball or trampoline?
I can't be dealing with it, me.
You hate nudists, don't you?
Nudists. I don't understand what it's all about at the end of the day. And here's something, right? Do you know, like, when you're a bloke nudist, right? Do you ever get any who just have, like, a small knob?
I don't know. I don't understand the question.
What's that? What's your point?
Well, you know, are there any blokes who are knocking about who just have a normal-sized knob or maybe a bit smaller than normal, who are happy wandering about showing off what they haven't got, if you know what I mean?
I don't think nudists are just doing it because they're so proud of their knob.
No, but there's got to be a little bit of that in it, isn't there?
Why?
Say, you know, Jonathan Ross, right? He's nipped to see you now and again and what have you.
He's what?
He sort of nipped in to see you now and again. He's always happy getting his knob out because he's known to have this big knob, right?
What do you mean he's known? Why is Jonathan Ross known to have this big knob?
No, he just talks about it a lot, doesn't he? He's always saying about, oh, you know, but you'd like this, wouldn't you?
But that's like me. I'm known for being a great lover. I say it a lot. It's clearly not the case. What evidence have you got that he's got a big knob?
No, but the difference is he's happy to keep getting it out. It's different sort of me walking about going, oh, I've got a big one and all that, but no one ever sees it. But Jonathan sort of, he's always getting it out, isn't he?
Have you seen him get it out before?
He did get it out, but I wasn't looking.
What do you mean you weren't looking? How do you know it was out?
Just because he sort of was moving it about and that, and I could sort of see. No, I wasn't looking though. It was that sort of thing where you can see something moving about, but you're like, I'm not looking at it.
What, like an owl seeing a mouse?
It doesn't matter. All I'm saying is.
So no, let's get back to this. You remembering vividly Jonathan Ross's penis?
No. I don't mean that.
Why were you looking at his penis?
I wasn't looking, though.
Well, it was clearly not meant to be looked at.
I'm just saying most blokes who, you know, nudists, they must be pretty confident in themselves to, you know, getting it out. And I wasn't looking. It's just that, I mean, I looked once.
Okay. What was it like?
Sorry, you looked at Jonathan's once?
No, I was looking at another one.
What?
At the same time?
No, why are you looking at loads of men's penises?
Where are you getting this?
It's natural, that's what I'm saying.
What do you mean? This is Carl takes a sneaky look at menscocks.com?
No, what I'm saying is, it's natural.
Where was this happening? You're in a gym.
No.
A lot of guys are getting changed and you're just checking out their
knobs. You're at your bedroom window with a pair of binoculars and there was a little fella across the road getting changed.
I was at some night out once.
Go on. So you were at heaven and you were in the toilet.
It was some night out and some people come running on the stage, right? Some music started coming on and these four people ran out. It was two women.
So you're at a gay strip club?
It wasn't gay in that. It was just a normal night out. Well, you know, some sort of party night out. Right. These people come running on, right? You got two women. You got two blokes.
Right.
They whip the knickers off. The fellas whip their undies off.
At the same time?
Yeah, all at the same time.
Was it like a choreographed thing?
Like, what's it?
Chippendales.
No, you know, like Cheryl Baker was in it. It was that thing where they sort of, you know, on Eurovision Song Contest.
I'm making your mind up. Yeah. When Bucks Fizz ripped off a larger skirt, conceding a smaller skirt. At no point did Bucks Fizz whip their knickers and pants off.
When you said Cheryl Baker was in it, I was thinking, what, didn't she used to host Record Breakers? I don't remember that. Tea Time on BBC One.
So that happened, and all I'm saying is, right, before I had a look at the woman's bits, right, I just had a little cheeky glance at the fellas.
Why?
Why?
Just checking it out, just seeing is everything normal down
there. Why weren't your eyes drawn instantly to the ladies' bits?
Believe me, I had a look at that. All I'm saying.
But you went to the guys first.
I didn't know how long pants were going to be left off for.
So you didn't want to miss your opportunity, is what you're saying? You saw a window of opportunity to see some men's bits and you thought I'd better take it.
No,
because this may never happen again.
No.
So what happened? So there's two women, two men, right? I don't know what sort of event this is where you're looking at anyone get their knickers and pants off. I don't know why you're looking at all. So you go right. There's knickers and pants off. Right. Let's check out the knob and testicles first.
You're telling me you've never, like, when you've been in a gym or anything, you've not just sort of turned your head, had a look, and go, all right, yeah, that's all right. Yeah.
Let's just get this question right. Have we ever been in a gym and just taken a sneaky glance at a man's genitals? Is that your question to us?
Right. For me, it's the same as when you see someone who's a bit odd, two heads or whatever.
Well, I'll be honest. If I was in a gym and a bloke came in with two heads, I'd look. I'd get a sneaky glance in the mirror. I'd go,
sorry, but you'd look at his genitals or his two heads?
His two heads!
Or would you sneaky look at the heads and then think, I wonder if he's got two cocks? And just...
I'd have to have a look there. If I'll tell you what, and now I admit it. If I'm ever in a gym and a naked man with two heads walks in, I probably will check out the genitals as well, just to make sure that he's got two of everything.
We all land, right? We're shipwrecked, okay? There's no food around. But there's a chance we might be saved, like, in a few days. We just got to stay alive just for a few days, okay? Mm. Steve offers up his penis.
For what purpose?
Well, it's already you've torn it in the car in the plane crash. Anyway, it's hanging off. You go, okay, listen, lads, let's eat this. This will go three ways.
I should be so lucky. Okay, fine, yeah.
I'll look for something else. Because we're surrounded by water. Why are we eating knob? There's loads of fish and everything. There's more fish in the sea than there is stuff on land.
Steve reckons, in ancient Greece, right, it was better to shag a bloke than a woman. And I went, well, yeah. I mean, that's about the male being sort of a first-class citizen. Yeah. Much better, wasn't it? An aspiration to sleep with a beautiful man than a beautiful woman.
Women were lower-class citizens, yeah. So therefore men were seen as higher class. So to have sexual relations with a man, there was no shame in that.
No.
In fact, it was looked upon
and
as
I said, well, it was, you know, ancient Rome. I said, even you know, Nero, he'd sit in his big jacuzzi and he used to get, you know, pretty boy men to just go into the water and just nibble at his testicles while he was having a wash.
He didn't do that.
He did? Yeah.
And he's not a gay fella?
No. I mean, you know, I don't know about Nero, but I mean, it wasn't a case of a big delineation between what was heterosexual and what was gay. It was just, you know, whatever you...
So what did this fella do then? This one who's having his...
Well, he was pretty much top boy, Nero, for a while.
He was in charge.
And, you know, and you did what you're told, if Caesar or.
But why were people going round though? Why didn't they go? Oh.
No, they weren't dropping in. It wasn't like the doors opening. I just can see what Nero's doing. It's not like when I pop in here to see you.
Normally what would happen is you'd say, "Come back to my place. I got a book for you."
Yeah.
You pop in. But you'd come out in his pants. Elton John would be on.
You'd have probably been like a delivery boy or a stable boy or something, you know. And you'd have popped round there and you'd have gone, "There, right, Nero. As the tablets of stone you wanted." And they go, "Pilkington, why you are here? Pop under..." I don't know why he's French.
What is that?
I don't know why he's French. "Just pop under the water and nibble at my testicles," and you'd have done it.
Because he was Nero.
I wouldn't.
He would have.
Well, there's no way I would have done.
Yeah, well, you would
have. What if I'd done? I've dropped a pizza off.
Yeah, you pop under Nero's place with a pizza.
I've dropped a pizza off.
Right, I'd say, I've done my job. Right.
Yeah.
That's not the sort of tip I wanted.
No, he'd have said, "Get the little baldy chap to nibble on my testicles," and you'd remember the water.
I wouldn't have done it.
Can I just say this, Steve? Not only would you be nibbling his testicles, you'd have been going mad. You'd have been noshing him just for extra. You'd have been doing everything he wanted. You'd have been going, "He'd have gone, I didn't ask you to do that." You'd have been going mental. They'd have been chewing, slurping, smacking, poking. He'd have chopped. You'd have gnawed his packet off. You think you're eating Walker's crisps? There'd be bubbles. There'd be blood. Oh, it'd be horrible. That book, that wasn't a fake. It wasn't like just a ruse to get you back to show you me in Dancing in Pants to Elton John.
What was your girlfriend doing during that incident?
I think she was just getting on with sort of like packing up sort of boxes because we were moving. I don't think.
Well, she's seen it all before.
Yeah. And the book was. Do you remember that book that I showed you? That it was Man's Body, an Owner's Manual. And it's just like loads of stats, and there's one in there.
Yeah, it's kind of like a Guinness Book of Records of
men. Yeah, yeah. There's one section there that was.
Sorry, hang on. It's not a Guinness Book of Records of men. That just sounds a little bit like you and I were sat around your house looking at a big book, picture of men.
The big man book.
The big man.
He is a big man, isn't he? Yeah. He should be on the front cover.
Yeah, it was a book more about the kind of physical body and
exactly,
about
biology and social and you know sex and all that sort of stuff. And
but we didn't look at the sex.
Which is where we got the knob news for today from.
right? This is true, right? I read that the you'll have someone's eye out. Knob News. Nearly forgot the jingle.
Yeah.
I read that the smallest ever functioning penis, right, was under 3/4 of an inch when erect.
Extraordinary.
That is bad luck, isn't it? And yeah. It's a micro penis, so it's perfectly scaled down. Just a little, look at Carl's face.
Well, couldn't the fella have said, look, right, I'm not happy about it, so I don't print it. It's not the sort of press people want, is it?
There wasn't a picture of him. It was anonymous. They didn't read the book and at work the next day and go, look at this, Frank. What? Smallest ever penis, 1/2 inch. He didn't go, it's me. He just went, yeah, loser.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Anyway, let's have a shower. I'm all right. I'm all right. He must have had to have a little jod with a pair of tweezers.
Yeah, presumably.
Because you couldn't even get a fist. I mean,
no.
That is bad luck, isn't it?
Was he a good-looking fella?
What would you do, right, if he'd invited you around and said, right, and he was like the king, right, and he went, oh, Carl, can you just go in there and just nibble at it? And you'd gone under the water, and you're just about to nibble at it, and you go, you come up and you go, that's tiny. Would you have been disappointed or relieved?
Right, well, that wouldn't happen.
No! Carl, I'm saying if it did, would you be disappointed? Would you go, oh, that, I can't even get, I don't know where to start with that, or would you go, oh, thank God it's not a big one?
You've got to remember that he's the emperor, so you've got to do what he says or he'll have you killed.
What would you do? Would you go, oh, I love lovely set of tackle, or, oh, it's not as big as I wanted, or would you secretly think, I'm glad it's not big because I didn't want to, because I'm not that guy?
I'm not even going to think about it, because I wouldn't do it. I know I wouldn't do it, even back then.
Even back then? What do you mean?
When was Nero at it? Well,
the Roman Empire was sort of like 2000.
Well, it stretched
up
for
to
years,
about, yeah,
years,
yeah, yeah. So,
it's a long time ago.
Yeah. Yeah, I wouldn't do it.
You'd have to, you'd have to.
I always remember, we're still doing Knob News?
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Just
Knob News Extra!
Knob News Extra, excellent.
Well, in, you know, I didn't do that well at school and that, right? But we had biology.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't take much of it in, but there was one day when it was about, you know, Knob News and stuff.
Sure.
And it was all about how, blood, you know, is what makes...
Engorges.
Yeah.
The erectile tissue.
Sure.
Yeah, it was all about that. And, there's this girl in our class called Paula, right? We were sat there watching it, and she fainted. You just heard her go, oh! And she hit the floor, right, because we were all sat on top of the desk watching this. But I wasn't that interested in that.
No.
I wasn't looking at it and that. But Paula, right, she fell over. And the funny thing was, right...
What was it, a video?
Yeah, a video of, like, this blood...
Yeah.
Doing the business to this fella's member, sure. Right? And, she fell over, like, and everyone's like, oh, what's up with her? And the teacher was trying to, like, wake her up and give her water and that. And it was really weird, because then the nurse came in, and yet this video was still playing. And the nurse came in, what happened? Well, have you seen this?
Yeah.
And you could hear, like, you know, then it was going on to, like, sex education on the video. It was all done from start to finish. What happens? Da, 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 and by the end, and she was still out cold by the time it got to, like, and then they had a baby.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right? And that just reminded me of it.
So it seems to me that that was her sex education class. She fainted when the penis got erect, and when she woke up, a baby was born. That's probably what she thinks happens. She's wandering around now.
And the whole class just missed out of it because they saw someone's face.
If she's ever with a bloke and he gets an erection, she just goes, oh, no,
well, that's it. She was a bit of a class tart, really. That's why everyone was like, what's
Carl,
up with her?
Carl.
No, she was. That's that. Everyone was like, what's up with her? She's not seen it before. But just reminded me then. Weird. But anyway, yeah, so I wouldn't
Anyway, let's leave Nero aside. Yeah. I've only just read about this, and I don't know anything about it. This naked rambler, Steve Goff.
Yeah.
Is he doing some kind of, he's doing a walk from Land's End to John O'Groats. Is he completely nude?
Yeah, he's been arrested 10 times on the way, apparently.
Right. It says here that Nora Goff, his mum, she's in her 70s, she's begged her son not to walk naked from Land's End to John O'Groats. She said, I don't know where he gets this from. Certainly not me. I am, and have always been, quite conservative. He would never have been allowed to walk around the house without covering himself up. I wouldn't go as far as to say I'm ashamed of him, but I do not approve of what he is doing. Having said that, it's good to see him on the telly.
Yeah, yeah, it must be.
It's not about anything, it's lovely.
It's not embarrassing until they're famous, would it? However embarrassing it is. But,
I can't believe my son's a serial killer. Nice to see him on the telly.
He looks like one. He's not, obviously. No. You know, I mean.
What is he doing? I don't
understand. Steve wouldn't say he was, and he's not. He's just a rambler. But he's there, right?
What's his motivation?
He's just walking to, I don't know, it's just a nudist, I suppose.
Right.
And there's a picture in there, and Carl looked at it and he went, oh. What's the point of that? He went, well, look at him. He's got shoes and socks on. He's got a rucksack on. He's got a hat on. He's not nude. He's just got his knob out. But I don't think he's got a full beard, thinking, oh, I want to hide some skin. Whereas this little chap needs the air. I'll pop him out all the time I can.
They really annoy me. Because it's in the supplement today as well, with the mirror, right? And they've done, done a bit about nudists and that.
Yeah.
Again. Same problems all the time.
Go on.
There's like an old fella sat there, just there.
How do you know he's old?
Well.
Why are you looking, Carl? Looking at his face, aren't you, presumably?
Yeah, I'm just saying he's old and he's sat there smoking a pipe.
Sure.
With his sandals on. Yeah. They're quite normal, just with his knob out. Yeah. Sure. But look, he always made the same mistake. He's got a little white deck chair.
Yeah, yeah.
If you're nudist, Don't go for white.
Why?
You're sitting on that, getting a bit clammy and stuff. White, don't go for white. Go for darker colours.
I don't know what he's talking about.
No, but I love it. I love the fact that he's just got loads of pictures of naked men.
Yeah.
Walking around with loads of pictures
I'm
of naked
men. I'm just saying, a dirty arse on that.
I think we've discussed the news before, though. I don't understand the impulse at all. I do find it bizarre. I mean, there's a picture there of three men nude in a pub.
Yeah. Just having a chat.
Yeah.
Just having a chat. Oh, look at Carl carrying around those pictures.
But what's the... I mean, okay, fair enough, walking around outside, but indoors? In a pub? Nude?
Well, it must be a nudist
pub. Pop on a pair of shorts.
That must be a nudist holiday, I assume. Yeah. As opposed to, like, the local.
There is, though, isn't there? There was a thing in Bizarre magazine the other week where...
Sure.
There was a picture of some people. They've got an airline of their own now.
What, nudists?
Nudes.
Nude airline?
So you can get on there. And your holiday starts as soon as you get on.
Sure.
And, but what's the point?
Well, I'd be worried just about banging against things. You know.
So to speak.
Yeah, my shoes and things.
Or spilling the hot when the waitress comes along. What, the hostess, and she spilled hot coffee.
Yeah, that's a good point. Would she have to be nude? Would the stewardesses have to be nude?
I don't know. But that bit as well, where they walk down the aisle and they have to check if you've buckled up.
Yeah.
She's like, excuse me, miss, can you just... And over 50s, it's always over 50s.
Right, yeah.
So it'd be an old woman on the plane.
Yeah, yeah.
She'd be like, can you just lift your left tit up so I can see the belt?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, God!
Yeah.
Oh,
imagine
dear.
If you've got to go into the crash position.
Oh, God, yeah.
You know? The last thing you see is your John Thomas.
John Thomas.
As you go crashing into a mountain. Terrifying. And then what if you've got an abandoned ship?
Yeah. I know. Well, how would they explain that?
Yeah.
Get onto an island.
Exactly.
All right.
Or being picked up by, you know, a passing ship.
Yeah. Carl, you notice they also play volleyball a lot, don't they?
Yeah, I mean, you've always mentioned that, but I thought you were joking, but they love it.
Yeah.
They said. That's what they do. They get to this special holiday
that
camp.
That can only be... Either they got the idea from sort of like Carry On Camping or Benny Hill, or they actually like it jiggling around as much as possible.
Yeah.
But is that safe?
Well, I assume so. You play volleyball with trousers on, don't you? I wouldn't have thought...
Yeah, but there's a bit of, like, support there.
There he is there.
Now, Rick, you may remember that last week we opened with some quality knob news.
Knob news, yeah.
It was
Hitler's knob.
Hitler's knob was one of them. That just sparked off into a whole bunch of other knob related discussions.
Yeah.
And I'm pleased so far to see that we're almost at the halfway mark for this first hour. And so far we've only talked about nudity and or Todgers.
Yeah.
So excellent work from us. Well done, lads.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to Dr. Fox and the rest of the Sony award committee listening to this one.
Yeah.
More knob news. I don't know if there's
a jingle
for that, maybe.
Oh, you nearly had my eye out! Knob news.
Knob news, excellent. This is an extraordinary story. A woman tried to sue her bosses for £210,000 after finding a cooked penis in a canteen stew.
Hospital cleaner Sophie something, I can't quite pronounce that name, was eating goulash for lunch and could not cut one of the lumps of meat. You can see where it's going.
I've got so many questions already.
I know. She picked it up and tried to chew it, but it was too tough. Then she inspected it with workmates, who all agreed it was a penis. Imagine that discussion.
Yeah, yeah.
Miss McLatter said she vomited for the rest of the day, instantly became a vegetarian, and had to have psychiatric help. It's not known whether the organ was from a human. The case continues.
Well, it can be found out, so that's one thing. Obviously, the doctors aren't confused. They're not going, I don't know, I've never seen one like it.
Yeah.
Also, why is she eating goulash?
I know.
I mean, that is my first question. Why? You got your, lunch, what do you want? Oh, fancy some goulash.
Yeah. Oh, some gooly lash.
Gooly lash,
thanks
like
very
it.
Much indeed.
Lancashire cockpot.
Oh,
is on the menu.
Brilliant.
Only £5.50.
Wangers and mash.
I'd love some wangers and mash, please. If you've got any knob food related puns, then call XFM on 3426 1494.
Ricky.Gervais at XFM.co.uk.
Call Chris Miles at radio1.xfm.whingingmank.
Yeah.
Cock-o-van.
Cock-o-van. It's already done for
there's
you.
There's wangers and mash, cock-o-van, Lancashire cockpot. You know.
That's just off the top of our brains.
Yeah.
So, if you've got any of your own, keep them to yourself, we're not interested. What do you make of that, knob news?
And it's in a hospital.
I don't think so. Yes, it was a hospital cleaner. You're right.
Oh, God. I know how your mind's thinking already.
There's been a mix-up.
Kind of mix up. I love that. What, some bloke's gone in, some lesbian's gone in, wanted a sex change, she's got a carrot for a cock. Yeah,
got a stew and steak.
Stew and steak. Oh, that would be great. You're not a doctor, you butcher. This is not funny.
There was some other news, whilst we're doing the knob news, just cram this one in. There was some story on some news website about some lad who wasn't happy with what he'd been given.
Right.
What do you mean? He had an op?
No, he wanted to have an op.
He wasn't happy with what God had given him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What the Lord had popped downstairs for him.
Sure.
And,
sorry, no, wait a minute. Was he a bloke who wanted it?
Yeah, a fella, yeah, a fella.
And what, he didn't want a knob, or he wanted a bigger knob?
Wanted a bigger one.
Right, okay.
And, cost £5,000.
Right.
They made a mess of it.
Well, how did they make a mess of it?
Don't know, it came out smaller than they went in with.
Well, no, what do you mean?
I don't know all the ins and outs.
He
borrowed the money off
his
mum.
There's been a slight mix-up.
He borrowed the money off his mum?
I love that.
How bad is that?
What do you want for your birthday, son?
Yeah.
Interesting. Thanks, Mum, for asking.
A couple of bits of news as well. Hello, Doctor. How did it go? Well, firstly, don't look under the bandages and don't have the goulash for lunch.
Yeah. God. It was smaller than you went
in
with.
Mum, you got £5,000. Why? Just give me fucking up. Tell me what it's for.
You can have it if you tell me what it's for.
Well, look at that. Oh, you need a bigger one. Yeah, definitely. There's the money.
Yeah.
On you go. Nothing can go wrong. What did he say to the doctor then? That's rubbish.
I didn't read all the ins and outs. I just, like I said, I saw
just
it.
Just look for the picture.
They want a picture.
But you just thought, well, thanks for it. You just thought you'd pop that one in. Thanks.
Yeah, that's the end. Knob News Extra. Yeah. Play record, Carl.
Not bad. I was on the way in today, right, Steve?
Mm-hmm. Walking in?
Walking in, always walking in. I get left early and stuff. I like to get in early, get some bits done and that.
Yeah. Monkey News, songs of phrase.
That sort of thing. And living in London, right, there's a lot of shops that open early and stuff, do you know what I mean? People say that's a good thing about London.
Yeah.
It's almost like 24-hour city and stuff, right? I'm walking in and there's like, you know, you've got your news agents open.
Obviously.
You know, selling newspapers and that's good, they've got to be open early.
Yeah.
Then you've got your coffee shops, your Starbucks.
You have a cup of coffee in the
morning. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
They're doing well in the morning.
Yeah.
Then you see like the odd restaurant and you think, well, maybe they sort of got the doors open, but they're preparing for lunch, so you think, fair enough.
Yeah, right. I'll let that pass.
Yeah. Carrying on walking down the road. Bondage shop. Open.
Sure.
Yeah. Half past 10.
Yeah.
Busy, was it?
There's a couple in.
Really?
Some good offers. 10:30. For a bondage shop.
I'm assuming if you're into bondage, though, you stock up at any time, day or night. I mean, you don't...
Yeah?
Well, I assume it...
I suppose you get up and you go, oh, I've got nothing on, I need to be a bit... Oh, I need to be a bit tied down.
Yeah.
I need some rope.
These clothes are too baggy, I need more belts.
Oh, God.
I need more straps.
Yeah, oh. Get some rubber on my face.
Weird, though, isn't it?
What were you doing in there?
So, I was just having a browse. So a bit worried, really, because the things that I've noticed this week, like that's probably a little bit smutty. You've brought your soup in.
I just found it out there. Yeah, it is Rooster's Pride cock soup, noodle soup mix, chicken flavour. But I mean, do they not know that is obviously just going to be used on the Graham Norton show and Chris Tarrant when he's doing his show abroad?
Yeah.
I mean, do you know what I mean? Well, how could they call it cock soup in this day and age?
Don't keep saying it.
Well, no, it's fine, because you say cock as long as it means the male. We've done this.
Oh, do you mean a chicken?
Yeah, look, it's a picture of a chicken.
Yeah, sorry.
What did you think it meant?
No, I don't know. I lost my head.
Okay.
Sorry.
Yeah.
But, there's something else that's a bit sort of...
A bit blue?
A little bit blue, but then it's real as well, do you know what I mean?
Well,
it's a problem.
Excuses it.
Go on.
There's a program.
We couldn't have said the cock soup if we'd made it up, but because it's real, it's fine.
Yeah, yeah. We also couldn't have said the cock soup if we'd have meant a male penis.
Thankfully, we don't. So.
We mean a little chicken. Yeah, go on.
This program was on. It was Wednesday night, something.
Mm.
About this little lad.
Mm.
Yeah.
It was a fella and a woman.
At the same time.
What do you mean?
Like a cartoon with a secret identity.
by night. What do you mean? He had both
by
sets.
Day a boy, by night a woman.
He had it all.
So he had male and female genitalia.
Yeah.
So what do you call someone that's born like that?
Weird.
Weird.
Then what's the term for it? Go on. You know it. We've talked about it before.
Aphrodite.
Nearly! So close! Hermaphrodite. Yeah, hermaphrodite.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's weird, don't it?
Yeah.
And he had, the ball.
Yeah.
And he had the...
Well, what happened was he was born, right?
Obviously.
And the doctor said, there you go. lovely little boy and girl. So the mum was like, what? So he said...
No, I don't think the doctor was sarcastic.
Yeah,
I don't think the doctor was sort of dissing them. Yeah. There you go. What do you mean, doctor? I'm gonna have a look. exactly. There's the cock, there's the minch. All right, see you later. What are you going to call? Hate. But doctor, what do you mean? Have a look. He wasn't sarcastic. He didn't give
doctor,
clues.
Tell me what you mean. Give me a straight answer.
He probably went, oh, shit, she's got a cock. He didn't go... He wasn't sarky to the parents.
No, but I'm just getting across, do you know what I mean? I always had a little bit just to...
Yeah, I know you do, yeah. You should be a newsreader. Be brilliant.
So, so there's a little kid lying there.
Yeah.
And the mum says, you know, what am I going to do then? So, the doctor... I mean, I'm condensing this. It was like
sure.
an hour long...
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, he says, what will I do? And the doctor said, well, he's not sort of well-ung.
Right.
Oh, for f...
So, he's
not sort of well-ung. This doctor has been, I assume, has been struck off since for saying these things.
It was a real doctor. It wasn't Dr. Fox.
Yeah. Right, go on.
So, the doctor said, so I recommend that we make it a woman.
Right.
Right. So, they sort of do a little bit of...
Jiggery pokery.
Yeah, a little bit of work. And
I don't think that's true, Carl.
No, it is. It was on the programme.
But I think they can tell really what they were meant to be from their chromosomes, or can't they? They can tell whether X, Y, Y,
yeah, not just... It's not it's very just, well hung.
No,
yeah.
I tell you what, because back then, when this was going
yeah,
on...
Yeah, no,
right,
I'm just thinking they might not have had...
The doctors then thought if you had a kid, right, and you thought, it's a bit ugly, maybe it'll have a better life if it was a fella. If it was a girl and it's a bit ugly and you think it's going to get hard time.
Right, don't talk shite.
What?
What, that a doctor would go, right, you've had a young girl, I tell you what, she's a pig, let's pop a cock on her. Don't
no, no,
talk
no, I'm not saying,
shite.
I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is, say if you have a girl, I just think it's harder, if a girl's ugly and
yeah.
she's growing up,
yeah.
she has a harder time.
Yeah.
Don't you agree with that?
Possibly, but you don't change someone when they
No, yeah.
You don't change their gender because they're a bit of a minger.
What I'm saying is the Elephant Man would have had a harder time if it was Elephant Woman, is what I'm saying. But listen to me, listen. What the doctor was saying is, if you get a baby before it's two,
yeah.
back then they thought you could sort of say, well, give it, instead of giving it a go-kart, give it dolls to play with.
Right, back when? What are we talking about?
The Middle Ages?
Well, we've put a song on, come back to this.
Yeah.
Okay, look. Have another go, Carl. What were you saying? As an hermaphrodite, yeah, it was born with both sexes. The doctor said he's not well hung, let's lose that.
Let's get rid of that.
Let's make it into a girl. Okay. I'm with you so far, go on then.
So, anyway, gets away with it a little bit in the early years.
Right. Right.
Starts going to school, gets away with it a little bit.
Sure.
Right. But then, do you know when you get to that age and your head goes all funny? Like when you're a teenager and you sort of, I don't know, your skull goes.
Mine never did.
What are you talking about?
No. That's when your head goes all funny. Teenage years when you look a bit odd. Do you know what I mean? You go from being quite a good looking person and then your body starts growing.
At different rates, so right. you never know till 21 whether you're going to be a looker or not, or whether it's just...
Yeah, yeah.
I know, right. Go on.
Yeah, I'm still waiting.
So,
your head grew outwards at exactly the same rate, didn't it? That's why it's
your head grew faster than your hair.
He's got a lovely head of hair, exactly. But just below the skull. Yeah. He's got a little afro in there, but it just couldn't get through the follicles. It couldn't catch up the skull. Expanding. Oh, bless him. Oh, come on, Baldy.
But the thing is, right, so you see these pictures of the lad stroke woman who's trying to be a woman at the age of 14, 15. Sure.
Yeah.
She's got one of them big heads.
Right.
Like a lad. She starts having a hard time. She doesn't want to play with the mates, with the dolls and all that. She's more into go-karting and that sort of thing. Gets to an older age.
Yep.
Decides to go back. Is now sort of with a woman and having a life of a fella.
But did the doctor keep it for him in case he needed it?
No, he's had one put on though.
Has he? Where'd he get that from?
Don't know, maybe that bondage shop.
What do they do when they do that? Do they put on a... What do they do? Maybe someone could call in and tell us. If you're a woman, and you have a...
Do you want to speak to someone who's got that information?
Yeah, I do want to know. What do they
if you've got that information, I don't want to talk to them.
Do they construct one? Do they construct it?
From plasticine.
Or do they whack on a dead one?
What?
What?
Whack on a dead one?
Yeah.
What? What, that's not... It's not... What do you mean? No.
When a woman has a knob put on...
Yeah.
To have a sex change, where do they get it from? Is it constructed? Do they find, like, I don't know...
From a donor.
A donut?
From a donor.
Oh, well, yeah. A donor?
Donor, yeah.
Yeah, but presumably it's like...
Maybe there's someone who wants to become...
After they're dead, I mean.
No,
very few people. It's not like giving someone a kidney and then sort of, like, celebrating with them.
Maybe if you're a guy and you want to become a woman, you go on despair.
That's true. Yeah.
But a swap?
Yeah, just do a little swap, probably on the internet or something.
Or Noel Edmonds.
What do you mean?
On Swap Shop.
He's not a man.
No, but he could go, we've got a fella here who got a lovely, nearly new, unused piece.
Yeah, Keith Chegwin out in kind of Bognor Regis.
Wants a couple of tits and a fanny for that, so call in.
It reminds me of the, do you remember the John Wayne Bobbitt story?
Which
always seemed odd to me. I never really kind of got all the information. Do you remember that one, Carl, where the woman cut off her husband's penis because he'd been adulterous or something?
When he was sleeping.
I think she wrapped, she drove off. I think he woke up quite quickly.
that's so much better than the
exactly,
alarm clock,
isn't
it?
Call. Yeah.
Yeah.
And she threw it out. She threw it out of the window. Car into the woods, and he went and found it.
Yeah.
But imagine if he'd got to the hospital and they'd sewn it back on, and he'd gone, that's bigger than I remember.
I'm not sure this is mine. How many of you got us where we dump all the knobs?
We dump all the knobs in there.
Yeah. That was
an extraordinary story. And then, bizarrely, he became a porn star.
Yeah. Yeah.
Very strange life that man's had.
Well, it is a bit of a shock to the system, isn't it?
Mm.
Mm. Oh, cutting your knob off.
I know.
Do you remember that French bloke, the performance artist of 1910? Do you remember him?
No.
As a performance art, in a theatre, he cut his knob off to a crowd of people. Now,
what?
That's only a one-night trick, though, isn't it?
Exactly. Yeah. But what if there'd been a bang outside?
He went, what?
Yeah, or they looked outside because a car backfired. He went, did you see that? Just cut my... Did you? Yeah. Think of that.
Sacre bleu.
I know. French are funny, aren't they? Cutting your knob off for your art.
Weird, isn't it?
As we're having so much fun with penises, yeah. I thought perhaps I should just mention...
That's a slogan.
That we should just mention this story briefly. It's in the paper today. A Russian is selling what he claims is Hitler's mummified penis for £12,000.
Yeah.
Ivan Zduprov says his ex-Red Army soldier dad hacked it off as a souvenir after storming the tyrant's Berlin bunker after his suicide in 1945.
Yeah.
Mm.
Not... Why did he wait till now? He's found out that... that might get a bit of £12,000.
Which doesn't seem a great deal. Doesn't seem a great deal of money, really.
Well, it's useless, isn't it?
True.
You're not going to be able to use it. It's not going to be able to... It's not going to be a donor. Imagine that, if you walked round.
You'll never... making love to a girl. You'll never believe who this is.
Yeah. You'll never believe who's doing you, love.
Exactly. This is going to freak you out.
Just relax. Okay, sit down now. Was that
I got a little surprise for
you. It was brilliant, yeah? So you enjoyed it?
Yeah.
Right. are you a fan of the Third Reich?
Exactly.
Well, no, awful racist. Okay, let's go a different tack.
Yeah.
You did like the sex. I love the sex. Okay, then. Yeah, it's not going to be Hitler's knob, is it?
But I like the idea that, I mean, you're in the Red Army.
Yeah.
You've just stormed Berlin.
Yeah.
1945. You crash into the bunker.
You've gone through terrible. How you've lost 20 million comrades.
Unbelievable.
Oppression everywhere.
It's been going on for years.
You're in there. You see the man.
Here he is. He's dead.
He's the
figurehead and leader of one of the most despicable.
You turn to your friends. There's a tear in your eye.
Yeah, and your immediate thought is, I ought to chop off his todger.
Yeah. 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 Well, no, I said Bagsy. I said Bagsy is Winkle. I said Bagsy is Winkle outside. Whoever it was. Yeah, I didn't know it was going to be Hitler. Brilliant.
It's just, I can't, it just doesn't make sense. It's ludicrous. And I don't know how is he expecting to prove this? Because I want some proof.
Well, I think that's why he said that. He probably started off with, I've got Hitler's face. And I went, brilliant. Oh, let's have a look at it. What do you mean, let's have a look? Well, just check Hitler's face, because obviously I know what he looks like. Oh, yeah. No, it's not, you know what he, no, it's not his face. What wouldn't you know what it looked like? Well, I mean, no one's ever seen his genitals. That's what I've got.
Yeah.
I've got his...
It's got a little swastika on it.
Is that proof, has it?
Yeah, a little
tattoo. Have you got his ball? Well, no, the Albert Hall's got one, his mother's got the other, so I don't know.
See, the Albert Hall, I would have thought, would probably be paying that £12,000, because apparently they've already got his ball.
Yeah, they've got one of his balls.
They've got one of his balls in the Albert Hall, his mother's got the other.
Yeah.
But if they got the Todger's
ball... If they can track down the one his mother's got, they would have a complete set of Hitler's...
I'm just hoping it doesn't fall into the hands of some kind of crazed genetic scientist.
What, I could clone it from his knob?
Could clone a Hitler.
Back to, I don't even want to think about the future if that's the sort of way we're going.
Exactly.
If that's the sort of way we're going, Carl, I'd rather not know about it.
What do you make of it, Carl?
Weird, isn't it?
It is weird. I mean, I don't want to go on for this too long. We've probably got about a minute left for the first half hour, and I reckon should can this sort of...
What, 30 minutes of genital talk? Just quickly,
there's one in a museum, I think it's like that London Museum.
What?
Well, do you know like how people are buying weird stuff and that to put in museums?
Yeah.
There's this device that, but I mean, think about it, years and years ago they used to torture people, didn't they?
Yeah.
Really badly. Mm. And the device
there's no real good torture, but go on, I see your point.
Yeah, but this device, right, think about it, you've done something really bad years ago.
Yeah.
Right, and you're thinking, oh, what are they going to do? Do you know what I mean? Could do anything here, it could be the end for me. The device they've got is this thing that you put on your bits as a fella. And it's sort of metal, so it means you can't sort of, you know, get excited. It puts a stop to you, sort of.
That wasn't a torture device. I think it was a Victorian thing to stop adolescent boys wanking. They used to have things like wrist things as well with, like, spikes on them. It's not a torture device.
Isn't that?
Well, not really. Imagine that being captured by, you're never getting hard on again. All right. Not really a torture device, is it?
And there wasn't that many nice-looking women wandering about anyway about them, was there? You wouldn't get excited about stuff.
What are you talking about?
Well, they're filthy, they stunk and everything back then.
What are you on about?
Right, we've covered that. No more of that talk now, right? Let's move on.
Filthy, stunk.
All Victorian women, filthy and stinky.
Yeah. Let's go back, if we may, shall we, to just some of the extraordinary... early developments in medicine. Do you mind if we...
Yes.
If we go back, just get back on message. There are, of course, a number of extraordinary developments. You may obviously be aware, Carl, that the first contraceptive diaphragms, centuries ago, were citrus rinds. Half an orange rind, for instance, would be used.
I mean, more selfish men turned them inside out.
I believe that's also still being used in parts of Manchester.
Ah, for what?
An orange. Just think of your head.
And it worked?
Well, we don't know at this juncture.
I mean, maybe...
It worked as a contraception because women went, fuck off, what are you going to do with a fucking orange on your cock for, you dirty cunt?
But it could, I mean, again, it's that thing, innit, of we look at it now and we laugh, but look at what's happening. People now are always trying to get us to eat more fruit.
I don't know.
Amazing.
That's a way of getting...
I thought for a minute he was going to say, okay, so they start with... Then they went from the orange rind to, say, a coconut shell. Yeah. That was too big. That didn't work.
Yeah. Run! Here comes Coconut John!
No, don't put half a pineapple on your cock. That's insane.
Yeah, that's mental.
And then somewhere down the line, they finally got to contraception as we understand it. Is that? I thought that's where you're going, but no, about eating oranges is healthy for you.
What I'm saying is, if you go into any well-known supermarket and you look at, say, some young kid who's had a kid... And you look at stuff in their shopping basket, they're not buying fruit. No. They're buying, you know, burgers and chips.
Turkey Twizzlers, crisps
and all that. Now, but they love having it away. Get some fruit in. So they definitely have fruit in the house, which at the moment, a lot of kids don't have fruit in their house. That's why they're eating Turkey Twizzlers. But the mum loves having it away. So she would have loads of fruit in. So everyone's happy.
If she was using an orange for contraception, she would also be giving the kids...
Well, you wouldn't waste it.
So half the orange she'd give to the kids and half the orange she'd stick up her penny.
Yeah, a treat for everyone. Have a bit of fruit and she's got what she wants. Whereas at the moment, what happens? A burger's not coming in helpful for anyone.
If you want me tonight, pop a sesame seed bun on your cock. Take out the fucking pickle. No one likes a fucking pickle up the fanny. Oh, he's a bloody romantic. Oh, he popped a plum roast sausage up me fanny yesterday. He loves me. There are people that help disabled people have intercourse where they can't, you know, maybe get on to the woman herself. And there's someone that actually helps the man put in his penis to the woman's vagina. And they leave the room. What?
I've never even heard of this.
It's true. Absolutely true. They're helpers.
Yeah, no, I believe that is the case.
Yeah. And that's just as needed as anything that might cure
them.
Well,
it's not. That's pleasure.
Yeah. So what are you saying? Because you can't walk or move, that you can't love someone and want to share that love?
I'm just saying it's not a priority.
Well, no, but they're going to live. They're healthy apart from their disability. I've met someone. They want to, you know, consummate this love, and someone is helps them out and goes, well, you know, that's part of my job.
No, it's not part of the job.
Well, it is part of this job because that's their job.
I have never heard anyone say, oh, I've had a right day today.
Why?
I've been playing with Arthur's tackle all day.
They don't with Arthur's tackle. They pop Arthur's tackle in Hilda's vagina.
I don't think they do.
They do.
How can they enjoy that? I mean, maybe once, and they'd go, that didn't work, did it? I didn't enjoy that, Hilda.
No.
How can they enjoy it with a nurse stood there having to do that?
They don't. No, they help her in. She helps Arthur in, or he, might be a male nurse, pops Arthur in, goes, okay, Arthur, I'll see you in a few minutes. Right, goes outside.
But what's the point, though, in that?
Why?
Because it's all about the mood and everything. He's just stuck onto her like a stag beetle clinging onto a leaf. There's no enjoyment in that.
Oh, the well-known stag beetle copulating with a leaf syndrome.
No, but
that's just saying... That's a well-known position in the Kama Sutra.
I think it's a lovely act, and someone's willing to... Wouldn't you help someone
definitely
in
there? Definitely not.
No? So there's a guy who goes, this is my wife. We're both say, well, I can't, you know, can you just pop me in, Carl? You're the only person around.
No, I don't think it's important
enough. But there are people...
What do you mean you don't think it's important enough?
I'd be happy to go round, put the washing on for them, make the bed. Do you want a cup of tea? Yeah, I'd love one. There you go. Oh, just before you go, forget it. If they asked me to do that, I'd quit. And I don't think it happens, because people wouldn't take that on for a job. You never hear about it. On Comic Relief, when they're raising money, they don't go, thanks to Midland Bank for this 100 grand, that's going to go towards Arthur getting his end away.
That's ridiculous. So you would rather them not have the pleasure... of each other than just help them in.
No, because they'd work out some way that they could do something for each other. I like to play the guitar. My fingers aren't long enough. I'd knocked it on the head. It's the same thing. If you can't do it, don't do it.
So are you telling me, right, okay, if there, supposing there's a little fella who's got no arms, no legs, right?
Right.
Little Bob, okay? There he is.
All right, Carl.
Right? He's got a friend, another little fella with no arms and no legs.
All right, Carl.
Right? They love each other. Two little fellas. Two little dwarves with no arms and no legs, okay? Lovely little fellas. They get married, okay?
Look, Carl, you can't put my penis up my boyfriend's bottom, can you?
No, I can't, no.
Why not? Why not?
Do you need anything else doing?
No, I'm fine, yeah.
No, it's weird how you can manage everything else.
Well, no.
I'm here to help you, everything else seems to be sorted.
Well, just in the chair.
Why do you need help in this department?
Well, because he's over there and I'm here, and if you just pop me in and just leave.
No, I'm not doing that, it's not good for you. You've lost your arms and legs, you'll be losing that soon if you carry on sticking it up there. If you're in pain, and I mean, like, I don't know if I told you when I had kidney stones.
I think you mentioned it.
I was in agony.
Yeah.
And they said I was in A&E, lying on my back.
Mm.
And the woman at the A&E counter said to Suzanne, "Who's that over there?" And she said, "Oh, he's with me. He's in agony." So they said, "What's up with him?" I said, "Oh, it's his kidney stones again." Because this is when I went back at the night.
Mm.
I was like, I couldn't care that people were staring at me. I was rolling about on the floor like a dying fly on my back. I just didn't care about what was going on around me. But I was told that because it's busy, that they might have to send someone out to shove, like, something up my arse that would get to the pain quicker.
What do you mean send them out? While you're rolling on the floor in A&E, they're going to send something up your arse?
What do you mean? A pill? I thought you meant to get to your kidney quicker than up your knob.
No, a pill. They put it up there and apparently it'll kick in quicker.
Yeah, yeah.
The tablet works quicker up your arse than it does down your throat.
Yeah, because it's a mucous membrane and it's...
Well, I was up for it. I just was like, whatever it takes. Now, saying that to me now...
But
now,
hold on though, what if the doctor said, okay, I could give you this morphine, take it, it will take a few minutes to kick in, or I could rub some on my penis... I pop an orange on the end of my penis, I rub that in morphine, and I pop that out of your rectum, Mr. Pilkington. Are you in agony or not? Are you in agony? Okay, look, I'm just smearing...
I'd say I'll get a second opinion.
Well, no, you haven't got time. There it is. Do you want this up your arse? It's covered in morphine. He's, in his private life, he's a promiscuous gay man, but in his professional life, he is a doctor with a morphine-smeared penis, and he's ready for action. So...
He's willing to do that in the middle of A&E.
Yeah.
So he takes no pleasure from that.
It's the only way. So are you in pain? Do you want this done or not? Yes or no?
He comes out into A&E reception, his trousers around his ankles, he has an erect penis, he says, "Carl, do you want me to stick this up your arse?" And your answer is?
Yes or no?
You're in terrible agony.
He's wearing a condom. He smeared the condom in. I mean, it's not unprotected morphine penile. Surgery.
Administration.
And what? In and out, done.
Just in and out, yeah. It just administered the your arse takes on the morphine from the doctor penis. And it's the only way, really.
In and out.
Yeah, in and out. Up once, okay? And out.
It'll definitely work.
You will. The pain will go away.
No side
effects. It'll be pleasurable,
no side effects.
Anything.
No side effects, no.
I'd probably call Auntie Nora and ask if she's had it yet. At the end of the day, we've all got to die of something.
Right.
Now, Albert might come in. I'm a doctor. Right, Albert, how are you today? What's wrong with you today, Albert?
I've got an inflammation of the testicular region.
Right.
My scrotal sac is all stretchy and swollen, it's pustulating, and it's causing the penis to be all red and inflamed, and that spread to the anus.
Right. Take these tablets.
Right, where do I put them? Where do I put them?
Just have them with some water after a bath.
Okay, I'm not going to have a bath. I can't have a bath with these. Because honestly, you see these getting a bath and they start bubbling with the...
Yeah, like I say, just take the tablet.
I don't know what it is, but it's... Look at it. It's like a mess. It's like quite a mess down there. I can't...
Take the tablets. Take the tablets and come back. in a week's time. Well, let me know how it goes.
Okay.
Right?
Right, so
do you know what it is?
Let's imagine that perfectly normal scenario has happened. What is your point?
Right, he'll come back the week after.
Yeah.
The problems downstairs will be sorted. Yep. But at the end of the day, he's 76. He's going to have something else wrong with him. I do another check on you. And even though your sack has sorted...
They're not quite right, to be honest.
No, but better.
Well, it swings and roundabouts because...
The penis is
much more functional. The testicles are really... They've lost all their skin. It's just like a bag of spaghetti just hanging on the chair. Mm. And the arse... The arse is the itchiest arse I've ever had. I've had to, at some points, I've got blood under my fingernails and scratching my anus. So it's not completely cured.
And this is why no one wants to be a doctor anymore.
I've always been fascinated in biology in general. And I remember when I was about 13 or 14, I got this book, Man's Body, an Owner's Manual. I was fascinated by it.
It's like a sort of textbook, is it? About
it's
the human
body. It's great though, because it's got absolutely everything from, you know, life and death. And then I was worried that you could chart when you die from sort of things like, you know, where you were born, socioeconomic group, have you had fill-ins and all that. I'd worry it, and you give yourself point system. But it's a fascinating book. It's got everything. And of course, all the stuff about male sex organs, you know. I can't think of the number of men that went home and got a ruler after reading about averages.
Yeah.
There's a nice little chapter here.
What is the average?
You have to push really hard with the ruler until it's sort of like going right into your stomach, and then you can get it up to like 2 or 3 inches. Lovely chapter here on sexuality. I want to read one. This is under the homosexual activities. It goes into what they like. Anal sex, it explains what that is. It's anal sex. This is inserting the penis into the partner's anus. Normally with the aid of an artificial lubricant, so it gives you all the details there. Now, in addition to anal intercourse, many homosexuals have practiced fisting, inserting a hand or fist or other objects into the anus as a form of sexual stimulation. Experience has shown, however, that this practice should be avoided since it can cause gay bowel syndrome. Now, I'd never heard of that.
Wow. Yeah. Gay bowel syndrome.
Gay bowel syndrome. Fissures, like lesions and stuff, and other damage to the walls of the rectum. So you'd go to the doctor and go, oh, I've got a problem with those. Well, you've got gay bowel syndrome. Are you gay? Yes, I am. Yeah. All right. Have you been sticking another man's fist up your anus? Yeah, yeah, we like that. Okay, well, my advice to you is to stop that because it's causing damage. Oh, thank you, doctor. I'm not going to stop it, by the way. I'm not going to stop it. I'm going to carry on doing that and then just keep coming back here with a sore arse, if that's all right. And you can just fix it, can you? Because I'm going to go home now and do it, even though you've told me that I probably shouldn't. And I'm going to. Gay bowel syndrome, you say? Carl, I mean, what do you think about that? Sticking a fist up your ass?
Wasn't meant to be, was it? I mean, it's not, you know, it's going to do damage, isn't it? It's like you've got to know when to stop putting stuff in a carrier bag, and it's the same as that, isn't it? Because it rips.
Yeah.
Someone told me this recently at a party. Fascinating fact. See what you think of it, Carl. He told me that apparently, if you've got time on your hands, you can put your fist inside someone else's arse, and then you can work your hand very slowly up through the person's body. It takes about 2 hours, apparently. And eventually, it's what he told me, you can touch that person's heart.
Right.
Right. And it's like the most intimate thing you could ever do with someone else.
That's bollocks.
That's what he said. That's what
our
bloke said.
How could you touch their heart? One, the alimentary canal is about 30 foot long, so you'd have to you have to be Mr. Tickle, right? Or you'd have to be rolling up the alimentary canal as you go, like a stocking on a pole, right? And then when you get up there, how can you touch the heart? You'd have to rip through the esophagus, which would kill them, okay? If the arm going all the way up their alimentary canal the wrong way didn't kill them.
But I like the idea of someone saying that to a loved one. All right, love.
Love, little surprise for you. The kids are at your mother's.
Yeah.
I've put the phones off the hook.
They're out for 2 hours.
They may be out for four because I'm going to need to get it back out again.
Yeah. Where's the Marge?
It's like, imagine the doorbell goes, you've got a sign for a package.
Who told you that at a party? A psychopath?
I don't know. And then he was convinced it was true because he went online to try and, even when we were at a party, he found a computer
also,
and he started typing in fist, heart stuff. And I said, you better delete that in case the person whose computer
finds fist, heart. Also, if the aim is to touch the heart, right, go via the mouth. It's shorter. Let's pop it down the mouth. Yeah. Kyle, thoughts?
I mean, there's getting to know people. I mean, do you know how people say, oh, you shouldn't use a toilet with the door open and all that because it ruins...
What,
like, you knowing too much and everything. But that, for me, where do you go from there? But I've got nothing against gays and that, but no. They puzzle me to this day. There's still things that happen when I go, what is all that about?
Like what?
I went to, what's her name? Harley Street. I went for a check-up. And, like a medical. Posh, you know Harley Street, it's like it's the top doctors, isn't it? I've never been before. Yeah. All posh buildings and that. Went up to the counter. I said, I see the doctor. They said, name, give us 10 minutes, go and wait in the waiting room. Dead posh waiting room. Dead fancy. Big leather furniture and that.
Yep.
Loads of magazines. I mean, like a newsagent's. Yep. In the middle of the room on a table. Loads of them. So I'm looking through and there's the top quality ones. Your Esquire, you know, GQ, Classy, Yacht Weekly, all that. Country Life. Boys? There's one there, yeah. Boys. What's that? Right, lifted up like the one on top of it. And it's like Boys with a Z. Two fellas stood there, looking, sort of Italian looking.
Right.
Remember Brother Beyond? That sort of look.
Right,
yeah. Sort of greasy hair.
It's a cracking reference there.
Dungarees on.
No shirt though.
No shirt, just dungarees sort of unbuttoned, hanging down a little bit.
Sure.
So no one else is about. I'm never going to buy a magazine like that.
You're going to tell us you looked through a kind of magazine?
I had a little look, just because I thought, you know, like I say, it's one chance.
You're always looking to learn, aren't you? You're always looking to learn.
Yeah.
Always open, you know, there might have been something in there that I go, right, I get it now, I understand why they like doing that or whatever.
Yeah, right.
So she said I was going to, you know, 10-minute wait. I can have a quick flick through. Mm. Picked it up, had a look. Still none the wiser.
Why?
Well, what did you see when you opened it up?
Just loads of, I mean, like I've said to you before about, I don't know why they like looking at knobs when they've got one of their own.
Right.
There's no surprises there. You're not going to go, oh, that's
sure, that's yeah. Nice. Yeah.
Lots of that.
Yeah, well, they can't get to it, can they? They can't get to their own.
Who can't?
Well, if they want a little chew, a little nosh, they can't get to their own, can they? They break their back.
But they can't get to this fella's in the magazine. It's only a picture. They're just looking at it. They might as well look at their own. That's what I mean.
Room,
yeah, just have a look at it. They just stood there. They're not up to anything. They were just sort of stood there. Some had, like, car oil on the face. There was one sat on a... don't know, just like a mechanic-type thing. Car oil on the face and, like, rubbed on the chest and that.
Sure.
Not about. Yeah. There was someone sat on, like, one of them square things of hay.
Oh, yeah.
Sat there, like, sort of sat on it, straddling it.
Yeah. That must have been uncomfortable.
Again, knob out.
Yeah, yeah, just looking like it's normal.
That's crazy. Like no farmer walks around like that.
What was the other one? There was a, you know, motorbike. They always like them.
Yeah.
So I'm going through and then, like, the content is all puns.
Right.
It's all, you know, it's a couple of weeks ago. Should I wrote some down? Everything was to do with knob.
Right.
That's the only bit they're interested in. In the male body.
Look at this bloke spreading this huge throbbing thing. The bike's not bad either.
Yeah, all that. Yeah. Loads of them. It was just cock. Just 100%. Like, let's just talk about the knob.
That's a good name for a gay magazine.
100% cock.
100% cock.
Did it not at any moment sort of maybe slightly unnerve you that you might, the doctor might come in and see you reading Boys?
No, because I wasn't.
What if I walked through? Because I remember once when you were in hospital about to have a tube going down your knob and you were sitting in your pants with stockings on and I walked through and you were horrified. So what if I'd have walked in then and went, yeah, Carl, what are you doing?
I would have just said, look at this. To this, it's free.
And I said, why did you bring that with you?
No, I would have just said, look, does it look like I brought it with me? Look,
yeah,
at this.
Yes, it does, because I've never, what? So you look, I would at... never see, you would never see a gay magazine in a doctor's waiting room. So I think you bought that and then and pretended that it was
that's,
there.
That's the thing. That's, I was amazed by that, because there was no, like, you know, there was no Mayfair or anything. They just catered for, like, if you wanted a bit of knob action. It was really, I mean, really, I could have complained. Sure. So if you're going to have this, where's a bit of the other?
Yeah.
But, yeah, you had a bit of this, where's a bit of the other?
I know one of the things that they had, and I thought, they're really struggling with, like, ideas. They had a Sococo.
As in Sudoku?
Yeah.
Sococo.
Sococo. Surely Sudico is better.
No, because it was like Sococo.
Yeah, but it's Dick as well.
Sudico.
Yeah.
What, and it was still a Sudoku-style puzzle, but yeah, it just had that name.
Yeah, yeah. It's just
so
everything. Not,
it was
all
just Sudoku, but called Sococo. That's amazing. That is amazing.
Now, if I was gay, do you know, like,
let's
they
have
say,
a game of Lubo. Let's have a game of Nobopoly.
Nobberation.
Nobberation. Let's have a game of chess. Cock. Let's have a game of fuckaroo.
Well, that works for either sex.
Yeah, that's true.
That's how we spend
okay,
our Christmases.
Then. Fuck a poo.
Oh, God.
Yeah. One square inch of skin, right, has 4 yards of nerve fibres.
In what? In 1 inch?
In 1 inch, square inch of skin. It's got 1,300 nerve cells and 100 sweat glands in a square inch of skin. And 3 million cells. Right, and 3 yards of blood vessels. Tiny, those tiny little things, and they make up 3 yards worth.
But I understand you need the blood bit, but the nerves, I'd shorten the nerves.
What do you mean?
I wouldn't have as many nerves. I think if I could change it...
Well, it depends, because there are different amounts per square inch. You've got less on the back of your hand than on the fingertips, obviously. And I think the most nerve endings are near your spine. Tip of the beard. Well, that's probably going to be quite sensitive.
Unnecessary, isn't it?
Unnecessary.
It is, really.
Why is it unnecessary?
Because I'd say what you want, I think you need them in your fingers because you're picking up hot stuff.
Sure.
I've never put my knob somewhere that I thought I didn't feel that.
There's a quote.
If you're sticking it somewhere bad, well, you shouldn't be, so it's your own fault, isn't it, is what I'm saying.
Yeah. Yeah, but I don't think it's just for your penis to be able to identify hot stuff. No. I think it's for other reasons why it's super sensitive.
It's not. Is that hob hot enough for your soup?
Well, hang on, let me just check.
Well, no, I've got a thermometer here. We don't need a thermometer. Well, no. The thermometer's not accurate. Well, it is. It's a mercury thermometer. Well, you need some, you know, I don't want a reading. I want a feeling.
No, you don't need it in that bit.
Well, the penis is sensitive, I assume.
Because of the sexual stimulation.
Yes, because you need to...
You don't need the nerves for that.
Well, you do, yeah, because you need... Well, something needs to stimulate it for it to know, to send a thing to your brain, and you go, all right, we're mating here, we need to get half our genetic material to that egg. I lost him, didn't I?
Yeah.
When did I lose him, though?
When you tried to explain how babies are born.